Welcome, everybody, to the birthplace of college football, Piscataway, New Jersey, on a glorious early November day. Temperatures in the 70s, the South Florida Bulls, they'll feel right at home in these temperatures taking on the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. This game is large. Why? Well, we check out the standings, and it shows West Virginia on top, Rutgers a game back. But South Florida, if it runs the table for the remainder of its schedule, the Bulls, in its first year, in their first year in the conference, can win the championship. Glad you could join us, everybody, for our high noon tilt again. Dave Sims, along with John Kinjemi. And today, John, we look at a South Florida ball club that hasn't played in 3 weeks. We'll talk more about that later. But Andre Hall, second leading rusher in the conference, he's going to get turned loose today.
Well, it's what they do best. South Florida runs the football effectively, and it's Andre Hall that does it on the ground. He gets those tough yards in the middle of the football field between the tackles. The big question at only 5'10", 205, can he run you over? Any questions? He can do that with vengeance, and he also can catch the football. 18 receptions for over 200 yards and two scores in the ground, so on the air. So he can do it all. He can catch the football. He can get to the edge. He's got great speed, Dave. Look for an exciting package in Andre Hall.
And for Rutgers, Ryan Hart, 18 of 21 last week, the once and future quarterback for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. He needs a hot hand again today.
Well, he's resilient. He's done a good job after being benched at the Syracuse game. He came off the bench, did a good job of winning the game against UConn, did a great job against Navy, and throwing the football and pushing it downfield, had a terrific completion percentage. But can he get the ball in the end zone against South Florida? That's the big question.
Let's take a look at our Taste of Tailgating, brought to you by Johnsonville Brats. Win a Johnsonville Super Bowl party with the world's largest grill. Go to johnsonville.com for details. The Rutgers faithful, they're ready, they're bowl eligible, and they want more. Let's see what happens today as they take on the South Florida Bulls. The opening kickoff is coming up next. Today's ESPN Plus game is brought to you by Advance Auto Parts. For the best parts, people, and prices, we're ready in advance. By Hyundai, with quality that lets them offer America's best warranty, 10 years, 100,000 miles. Allstate, a proud sponsor of the Bowl Championship Series. Johnsonville Brats, welcome to heaven on a bun. Welcome to Johnsonville. And by Suzuki, introducing the all-new Grand Vitara, the authentic SUV. Glorious day here in Piscataway, New Jersey, as we look at Jim Leavitt in his first visit to New Jersey with the South Florida Bulls. And they'll be kicking off. Jim is the father of this program, been in since day one, came over after being the co-D coordinator at Kansas State with Bob Stoops under Bill Snyder. Greg Schiano in his fifth year. Have they turned the corner? This is a pivotal game today. Coming off the big win last week. Similar circumstances a year ago. They beat Michigan State here, and then they spit the bit in a big way against New Hampshire, 1AA ball club, the following week. Here they are against a new South Florida club that hasn't played in 3 weeks because of the hurricane and a bye. So here we go.
Yeah, you think South Florida is going to be animated going down on this kickoff after being off for so long?
Justin Tichy kicking it far side. Willie Foster 2 yards deep, and he'll keep it right there. Saquon Underwood told him, no, I think we should take it on the 20. And the Scarlet Knights will put in play at the 20, and Ryan Hart, senior, benched a few weeks ago when we were at Syracuse with Rutgers, and has come on nicely. He's third in passing efficiency, third in the Big East in passing yards per game, third in total offense. So having a nice year. 60% of his passes, 1,307 yards, 11 touchdowns and 3 picks. Rutgers has about 4 or 5 quality offensive weapons. That's Clark Harris, the tight end, resetting. Put it in the air. Get it out in the flat to Leonard. 25-30. First down. 34-yard line. Rutgers. Nicely done. Take a look at the gentleman who will be moving the ball up and down the field for Rutgers. And the excitement building already. Brian Leonard, 6th in the Big East in rushing. Ray Rice is 4th in the Big East in rushing. Harris, a big time catcher. Chris Moses holds just about all the records here. And Tucker having an outstanding year as well. Mike Fladell in at left guard, and a veteran group up front led by John Glass. Out of the shotgun, and Leonard gets the call. And he's taken down in there by Ben Moffitt, the middle linebacker. Take a look at the South Florida Bulls. First contest in 3 weeks. be Simmons, Cray, Jones, and Royal. And Simmons, big time player, like the punt of Penn State. The linebacker's very good. Fastest of the group is Stephen Nicholas. Moffitt's the top tackler. And in the secondary, Jenkins and Williams at corners, they can fly. Williams at the safety along with Johnny Jones. Jones is the leader of the DBs. Second down play, hard deep drop. Plenty of time and throws it out, tried to get it to Sean Tucker. And that's incomplete. Covering on the play is Trey Williams, number 21.
Good pressure by Stephen Nicholas, the outside linebacker for South Florida. As we look at Ryan Hart's, the season numbers, third in the Big East, 11 touchdowns. You love the touchdown to interception ratio. He did a great job last week against Navy, 18 of 21 for 221 yards. Did a great job of controlling the tempo of this offense.
Look at the sunshine here at Rutgers. Boy, this is tremendous. D coordinator Rich Kravitz yesterday said for South Florida, we might not have been able to get the guys off the bus if it had been 50 degrees. Should have been a pick there by Ben Moffitt, the sophomore from Bushnell, Florida. Had his hands on it, and Rutgers will punt.
There you see the quickness of this South Florida Bulls bunch. That window really closed well, and Rick Kravitz loves the way his defense runs through the football. He says, hey, we're just going to line up and tell everybody, run to the ball, and that's exactly what happened on this play. There's a window to throw the football in right there, but it closes awful quick. Ben Moffitt comes with that hand and closes that window on Ryan Hart, trying to get that football down the middle.
Joe Radigan to punt, seventh in the Big East, averaging 32.9 per punt. Gets into it, hangs a beauty. Amari Jackson, a game breaker, signaling for a fair catch, makes it about the 17-yard line. 4-6 on the hang time, a 47-yard punt by Joe Radigan, a beauty.
First and 10 at the 17.
Amari Jackson, one of the game breakers. He had the career-high 3 touchdowns against Louisville.
That's a dream game he had against Louisville.
Pat Joel missed. He is the quarterback out of Miramar, Florida. Completing 51% of his passes, 5 touchdowns, 5 interceptions.
Hey, you got to be in front of
it. Last game against Pittsburgh, passed for 222 yards, and it goes spread. Trips to the bottom of the screen to the left. Gets it outside to the game breaker. And Amari Jackson, the 6'5 receiver, his 10th catch of the season. And that is close to a first down. And it is a first down. They pick it up. Backs and receivers, Andre Hall, we told you about him. Chambers, Green, Amari Jackson, a game breaker, and Carter with just 2 catches. And that came on a pass from Amari Jackson. And on the front line, a good group. The strongest of the bunch is John Miller, the center. Walker, Carruthers, Miller, Davis, and Watson. First down from the 29. Here's Hall, first carry. Hello, look at this. Second, third level. He's in Rutgers territory at the 45-yard line. First down, South Florida Bulls. Nice gain there by Andre Hall. Picks up 26. Here's the defensive line. They've been doing a great job putting pressure on quarterbacks all year. Ryan Neal and Val Barnaby among the leaders nationally at sacks and tackles for losses. Javron Thompson is has one of the top tacklers on the ball club. Frierson and Lewis are having outstanding years. And in the secondary, veterans here, Roberson, Geralt, Green, and Barnes. And Green is the number 2 tackler in the conference behind HB Blades of Pitt.
Well, Dave, if South Florida can go back and Julmus can throw hitch routes and they can mix in Andre Hall running the football, just no one in his way off the right side. Great job controlling that offensive line. He runs right through another arm tackle to get 5 extra yards. But Andre Hall, this is a guy that needed the rest. He was a workhorse. He's been a workhorse all season, second in the Big East in rushing.
Coaches say he doesn't take a playoff, loves football, ran through a tackle, and he's on a roll already. Big chunk of change there to the 38-yard line, picks up 8. Nicely done. And Courtney Green has to come up from his free safety spot to make the tackle. Part of that crew from New Rochelle High School in New Rochelle, New York.
Well, if South Florida can run the football, it really takes that defensive front of Val Barnaby and Ryan Neal pressuring the quarterback out of the equation. And right now, South Florida getting off the football very effectively.
Number 3 rushing team in the Big East Conference. Joel Miss, the quarterback, hands off the Hall. Ooh, good fill of a hole right there. Looked like he had some running room. Mike Frierson got in to make the tackle with help from the middle linebacker, Devron Thompson. Take a look at this.
Talk about filling the hole. Here's your guy right here.
Oh, yeah.
Great job by Thompson. Reading the play from outside in, goes in and lays the lumber to Andre Hall. Watch the reaction. A lot of low running on the inside, but no hesitation by Devron Thompson, the senior out of Piscataway.
Hall, three carries, 35 yards, third and one, and they get the first down. They go to Ricky Ponton, the freshman from Tampa's Hillsborough High School, redshirted last year, averaging almost 4 yards per carry. First down, Bulls.
Dave, when we were talking about both of these teams yesterday, we talked about the similar body types and the athleticism of South Florida compared to Rutgers. Really the same athletes on both sides of the football, and it's a battle of who's going to win the line of scrimmage to make it easier for their athletes to make plays.
Well, one of the things we want to talk about today, how about the folks that South Florida has played to this point as compared to Rutgers? Three first downs on this drive already for South Florida. Just underway first quarter, 3 minutes in. They give it the punt. Oh, they're getting nice pieces of yardage there. Neal got the secondary tackle. The first level tackle was Devron Thompson. And South Florida, if they can run the ball, and this can be said for a lot of clubs, but when they run the ball effectively, it opens up a whole bunch of things. And look at that success right there, John.
Yeah, the first four games, they had a 3-1 record. They were pounding the football. In the last two games, 0-2. Why? They haven't averaged close to what they did in the first four games, so they need to control the line of scrimmage and rely on Hall and Ponton in that offensive backfield.
216 yards is what they averaged so far, and look at that, pitching a shutout, 45-0. Second down and six. Hunt, big running room, left side, taken down by Courtney Green by the collar at the 14-yard line. That's good for another first down for South Florida. Gain of 11.
Green on the stop.
Well, credit this offensive line, a huge hole before Courtney Green is able to bring Ponton down. But Ponton, you thought Andre Hall was explosive. This freshman can get it outside. Watch him protect the football, moves it away from Courtney Green. Great job at the point of attack, though. Good job by that offensive line. John Miller, that center, he gets that nose tackle turned around, and that started the downhill running left side.
Offensive line has really asserted itself in his first drive. They'll keep it on the ground with Hall, and this time he's blown up right in the middle. Looked like he was trying to cut it back to his left. And pretty nice job in there by Rutgers. Ryan Neal and Luis Rivas in on the stop.
I'm impressed how fast and how quick both of these backs are for the Bulls. Andre Hall doing a great job in punting. Really, they get through the back end of that hole, Dave, with quickness.
Sure do. Second down and 10. Ball's at the Rutgers 14. First drive for South Florida. Gilmist is going to keep it, and he got a wall. He's at the 5, and he's down to about the 2-yard line. That'll be a first and goal for South Florida. Gain of 12. So big numbers every time South Florida runs to the left side behind Theo Watson, Frank Davis, and the center, John Miller.
Yeah, and credit Chris Carruthers and Derek Carter, the tight end on that play, doing a great job. Really, it's just counter left, and they turn everybody inside. Look at the job that Chris Carruthers does on the edge, and plenty of running room to the short side for Julmas.
One pass, 8 runs on this drive. Julmas gives the Hall, diving in. He's in, touchdown, South Florida. 6-0 Bulls. 2 yards on the run, and no doubt about that drive. Relentless drive, threw it just once, and that's establishing what you want to do. And the coaching staff said, hey, we're going to turn Andre Hall loose, and that's what they've done.
And that's what we talked about in the open, Dave. The Bulls are going to run the football, and they're going to run it with Andre Hall, and they did it with great blocking on the inside from this offensive line.
Here's Kyle Bronson, a freshman from Wharton High School in Tampa, for the point after. And it is good. Perfect 17 for 17. How about that drive? As South Florida makes its first appearance here in New Jersey, and they ring the bell in a large way with a drive taking it all the way in. Andre Hall capping it, and it's 7-0 South Florida. The best seats for every event. No tickets required. It only happens in one place, only Vegas. First drive of the game by the South Florida Bulls. They take it all the way in. 10 plays, 83 yards, and 3:47. Andre Hall, a 2-yard run. Big play, his 26-yard run on the second play from scrimmage. Foster will get to touch it in play. Return right from the 5. Fake the reverse. Got a big hole. Willie Foster. Oh, and he slips down. And a good close there. Helped to slow him down.
Foster on the return.
But that was a 27-yard return, and Willie Foster looked like he was going to break one big. Justin Tichy, the kicker, makes the play.
Now, Ricky, you get out in the open field, get some body language.
And there's Andre Hall, tied the career record. All-time touchdowns at South Florida.
An impressive drive. 10 plays, 83 yards, a lot of clock, and 71 yards on the ground for the Bulls.
All right, so Rutgers needs to respond. And they give the ball to Ray Rice. He's got running room. Oh, good tackle, and that saves some big damage there.
Ray Rice, the ball carrier.
Gain of 5 on the play.
Jones on
that
the
was
set.
Johnny Payton. Make that Johnny Jones. Beg your pardon.
The hole closes. There's a hole to run up there, and Ray Rice did a nice job of trying to elude the tackler, but Johnny Jones, he's the leader out there of that secondary. He'll come up and hit you. 28 total tackles, but Ray Rice showing you some good speed out of that backfield. Only a freshman, third in the Big East with over 600 yards rushing.
Sets up a second down and 5. Got a bunch formation, top of the screen. Toss play, run it that way with Rice. Good head of steam. First down Rutgers to the 40-yard line. Nice job in there. Picks up 9.
St. Louis on the stop. And
Carl Williams in there on the stop.
Well, Rutgers answering the bell a little bit when you want to play smash mouth football. Good job at the point of attack. Clark Harris, watch him come down and just pin the defensive end, Terrace Royal, inside, and then a good cut block by the offensive line gets Ray Rice going north and south in a hurry.
Pedro Sosa did a nice job over there as well, the left tackle. First and 10 Rutgers at the 40. End around to Chris Baker. Gonna throw it, got a man waiting, and it is penalty flag. Probably gonna be in Dewan Brown. It was broken up by Carlton Williams. Trez Moses, the intended receiver. Sean Tucker, make it Chris Baker. There was a high school quarterback, got the ball down there pretty nicely.
Pass interference, defense, number 42. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Jack Kramer, the referee, umpires Ron Cuniega. Troy Gray is the head linesman. The line judge is Jeff Cooney, and Pat Garvey's the side judge.
Dewan Brown, 42 for the Bulls, has his back turned, but the underthrow was where he got in trouble. He had nice coverage, and Sean Tucker was way behind trying to come back and make a play on the football, but a good job and a good result for Greg Schiano's club. They needed to stretch those Bulls out so it opens up more running lanes for that running attack.
From the South Florida 45-yard line, it's Leonard in motion. Screen to the left, and they saw it blown up beautiful. Well done by Patrick St. Louis, the junior linebacker out of Miami. Number 2 tackler on the ball club behind Ben Moffitt, the middle linebacker.
Dave, we talked about Pedro Sosa doing a good job on the play before, but that time he let Patrick St. Louis run right by him. You're going to watch Pedro Sosa come outside on the screenplay, and he's got to hit the first white jersey he sees, and he doesn't catch up to Patrick St. Louis. It really puts Brian Leonard in a catch and get hit situation.
Loss of 3 on that play. All right, we'll back up. Shotgun formation. Blitz coming from the corner. It's picked up. They read it. And a completion. They get it to Sean Tucker out of Parkland, Florida. A whole bunch of Floridians in this game. Only 3 players on the South Florida roster not from Florida. And then Greg Schiano has made a big deal and very effective ploy in getting 25 players from Florida on this Rutgers roster.
Yeah, if you're not from the state of Florida and you've got a white shirt on, don't need to apply.
There's a bunch of matchups being rejoined here. Willie Foster going to go to the top of the screen here. Third down and 4 for Rutgers. Martin, good time. Over the middle, no sir. Tried to feed it into Sean Tucker. That ball got deflected. Trey Williams got a piece of it. There's Trey, number 21, out of Plant City, Florida.
Dave, when we talked to Rick Kravitz, the defensive coordinator for the Bulls yesterday, he really likes the play of his cornerbacks, Mike Jenkins, 4, and Trey Williams, as we just saw on the corner, on the edge, number 21. They do a good job of breaking on the football, and they say those two guys are probably the 2 of the fastest guys on the team.
They're so happy to be hitting somebody in another uniform right now. It's unbelievable.
Right. Could be a fake here to go.
How about this? Rutgers getting exotic on us, and now what do we got? A timeout called by South Florida. Good job.
Yeah.
They burned the timeout as opposed to getting burned big time here.
Yeah, Coach Leavitt likes the alertness of his defense calling timeout there. I don't think they were prepared for it. And Greg Schiano on the other side saying, hey, guys, if you got the advantage, run it.
7:22 in the first. Rutgers trying to match that South Florida score. Big game for both clubs. Big East football on the air from Piscataway, New Jersey. Glad you could join us, everybody. More college football excitement coming up right after this. Well, after a nice Friday night on campus, up early, college football on the to-do list. The folks have showed up here for South Florida and Rutgers in our Suzuki walk-on way of life. And we salute John Simmons, walk-on, and he's turned out to be a very productive player for the South Florida Bulls. 48 yards, a last punt by Joe Radigan. Going for the near corner, hangs it up nicely. Bounces at the three. Oh, just missed. That was Marcus Daniels, who's had an outstanding year in downing punts all season. And that punt out of bounds. That was a 39-yard punt. Good job by Radigan to hang it up there for 4.5 seconds. Nicely done. Let's take a look at our BCS standings brought to you by the good folks at Allstate, a proud sponsor of the Bowl Championship Series. Southern California still on top with Texas right there. Virginia Tech with a humongous game tonight against number 6 Miami.
And yeah, there's only 5 unbeaten teams left in the country.
Here's South Florida, second possession of the day, and Hall breaks another one. First down and more. Andre Hall picks up 13. Make it 14, and another first down for the Bulls.
You know, the Bulls were kind of worried about being off all this time, but I think it really did Andre Hall some good. This is a guy that has great vision and balance, and he shows you all those assets on the play right there, and he's got great strength to the outside. Never takes a play off, Dave. This is a guy that works at it at practice just as hard as he does on game day.
6 carries, 51 yards, a 2-time junior college All-American at Dixie Hollins. Here's Jomis going to pass for only the second time. Got a man down. Oh, what a catch! My goodness, Johnny Payton, hello. First down, South Florida to the 43-yard line. Gain of 23.
Talk about going up and climbing the ladder. Look at Payton just reach that right hand up there, the sophomore from Dade City, Florida. Great catch. Came into the game with only 12 catches, but 3 touchdowns, and watch him elevate to get up to this ball. Just catches the point of that football perfectly and brings it down for a terrific reception. Hopefully he's not hurt on the sidelines. Looked like he came down, ran right to the sidelines, and the training staff for the Bulls attending to him right now.
Apologize for the audio problem, but a penalty against illegal substitution against South Florida. Well, Johnny Payton, great catch. He was the top receiver a year ago at 22 catches. Big time, deep threat. They'd like to get him down there. And the other thing too, John, we talked about this with Greg Schiano. Amari Jackson, 6'5". Johnny Payton, 6'5". Turn those big fellas loose. The tight end, 6'4".
And they got some size on the outside.
They can do a post up down there, and a lot of these DBs. Tallest one is 6'1", Courtney Green. First and 15, Hall gets it. Look at the blocking and the patience there. Gets on the outside and taken out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Nice game there, picks up 8. Glad you could join us, everybody. Big East football for the birthplace of college football in Piscataway, New Jersey. And the first meeting ever between South Florida and Rutgers. South Florida with wins in its remaining conference games can win the Big East championship. And Rutgers, bowl eligible for the first time since 1992, trying to stay on the upside. And here's your first down story along with John Kajemi and Dave Sims. And second down play coming up here for South Florida. Joe Miss, they'll keep it himself. He's got the first down. Penalty flag coming in. Gain of 9 on that play. South Florida's got some, that Florida speed. I mean, I can't say we're surprised. Here's a penalty going against the Bulls.
And that's a bad penalty, David. It's on the outside. SL Green for South Florida gets called for the hold.
Holding. Offense. Number 81. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat, second down.
Yeah, one of their extra wideouts, junior out of Brandon, Florida, SJ Green.
It was a perfect situation. Man coverage. You see the free safety move over, and it's man coverage. No one can account for the quarterback but that free safety. So if you're the quarterback on the option, Jolmus gets the edge very easy, and the holding happened about 15 yards away from the play.
Three penalties, 30 yards thus far for South Florida. They average about 8 penalties a game. Here's Jolmus out of shotgun screen, and they get it to Jackson. Take it down by Val Barnaby. Barnaby peeling down. After seeing the screen coming at 3 yards on the game.
And Derek Robertson, the cornerback for Rutgers, did a nice job of seeing the screen coming at him and forcing it. Watch Derek Robertson force the play back to the inside, right to Val Barnaby. He does an excellent job of meeting at the ball receiver, and that's exactly what happened there. Amari Jackson, no running room because Barnaby coming from the inside and Robertson coming from the outside.
From the 41, a 3rd and 8 for South Florida. Rutgers shows blitz. They bring it. Jolmus hanging in, flushed, throwing downfield. It's caught by Jackson. He'll be short of a first down by about 1.5, 2 yards. Amari Jackson makes the catch. Gain of 6 on the play. Covered down there by Joe Porter.
And the Bulls want to go for it. Good athleticism by Jolmus. Watch him elude the first rusher right there. Corey Barnes can't bring him down. He has the vision. His eyes never left downfield, never left Amari Jackson on the comeback. Watch Jackson work back to the quarterback and to the sidelines. Good job by quarterback and receiver being on the same page.
Andre Hall, Pat Jolmus, they wanted to go for it, but Jim Leavitt says no. He's going to send out the number one punter in the Big East, Brandon Baker, senior from Lake Placid, Florida. There he is, number 47. And now we've got a timeout on the field. 7-0 South Florida. Andre Hall, a 2-yard run, capped an 83-yard drive. The Bulls on top here in New Jersey. Back to Piscataway right after this. Welcome back, everybody. 7-0 South Florida. South Florida leading, and they're going to go for it here on fourth down. And why not? When you've got your running back averaging 8.6 yards per carry. This is what South Florida has done on the season, 7th play of this drive. Jolmus gives it to Hall. Oh, he didn't make it. Great play, and it looks like Ryan Neal, number 91, made the big play for Rutgers. Ryan Neal won his battle, and a big one for Rutgers.
Ryan Neal, he's second nationally in tackles for loss. You can see why. Wins the battles at the line of scrimmage. Ryan Neal does an excellent job of coming down and winning that battle. He runs all the way down from the right side. Great job by Ryan Neal. Terrific job of pursuing down the line of scrimmage. Here he is. He's going to come right down the line of scrimmage and catch Andre Hall in the backfield. Watch him. No delay. Gets it right inside and stops him on fourth down.
Here's Hart trying to capitalize. He's got time. Oh, boy, bad throw. Penalty flag on the play. And it's thrown back towards the old lineman near Pedro Sosa. The intended receiver was Ray Rice. And tripping called against Rutgers. John, let's look ahead here. Let's evaluate this for a second. 7-0 had South Florida. Tells you how big Ryan Neal's play was. If they keep that drive going, and they make it 14-0.
Tripping offense. Number 76, 15-yard penalty, still first down.
John Glass, the senior from Allentown, called for that. That's how big a play Ryan Neal's performance was there.
Well, he breaks the momentum. I mean, South Florida, the Bulls offensively, they've only thrown the football a couple of times down the field, so they feel like they can run at will. And it was a matter of will, and that's the guy, Ryan Neal. He's the leader of that defense for Rutgers. He makes a big play.
Got another question for you. Penalty was a trip for 15 yards. We'll do it right after this. Here's Hart going to throw again. And ball's up in the air. Kicked off. Penalty flag two. But this is going to the house. Johnny Jones, touchdown, South Florida. Johnny Jones with the INT. Let's see what the penalty is. Let's see if it's going to come back. 32 yards on the return. And that ball came out fluttering. Pass interference against South Florida saves Rutgers. On that note, talking about how the ball fluttered out, how long, Elise, are we looking at with Ryan Hart, given that Mike Teal's coming off a shoulder injury, and he does, and maybe he does throw a little bit better ball.
I think the ball was tipped, and I think that's what the officials are going to talk about on the field right now. That didn't look like pass interference, and that looked like an interception for a touchdown, and that's why Jim Leavitt is so animated on the sidelines. You can see Ryan Hart, this ball does not come out cleanly, and it's tipped right there, but it's tipped by the offensive receiver.
On the play.
They wipe it off. They called it off.
And Greg Schiano's halfway on the field, and he wants an explanation.
It got tipped in the secondary, correct?
Yes, it did not get tipped at the line of scrimmage.
I was looking at the line of scrimmage.
Let's take another look. This ball comes out, and it's fluttering. I don't believe it was tipped at the line of scrimmage. And it goes right in and out of Sean Tucker's hands into Johnny Jones. So I'm not sure if that ball was definitely not tipped at the line of scrimmage.
It was not a good throw. It wasn't tipped. It was tipped right there by the receiver.
Yeah, the first person that tips it is Sean Tucker, the intended receiver.
Johnny Jones, a 32-yard return. There's Bronson for the point after. And it is good. 14-0 South Florida Bulls. That ball just didn't come cleanly out of his hands.
That's the second ball that Ryan Hart has thrown to the right side that has come out fluttering. And I think that Mike Teal, if he wasn't injured with his right shoulder, may be warming up and getting ready to come in on the next offensive series.
14-0 South Florida. And that is quieted the pretty good-sized crowd here, expecting upwards of 30, 35,000 here at Rutgers Stadium. There's Mike Teal. We saw him get his first start a couple of weeks ago against Syracuse. Hurt his shoulder against Connecticut.
Yeah, big guy, 6'4", 220, only a freshman. Had a terrific high school career. And he did get that start and got his first college victory on the road in the Dome against the Orange.
So this changes the complexion of the game now. And the South Florida folks, and talking with them yesterday at the hotel on our visit, said, hey, and we hear it every week, but it's so true. We want to make them one-dimensional. They get out front. Jim Leavitt's club's out 14-0. And now defensively, he can start dictating some things.
Well, you're glad you have a senior in, Ryan Hart, that's been in a situation. You know, against UConn, he came off the bench trailing 10-3. He goes 5 of 11, only threw for 94 yards. But the big thing, he threw three touchdowns. And Greg Schiano, I think, realizes that that wasn't the proper call. The ball was never tipped at the line of scrimmage.
Sure, and wasn't.
It cost him 7 points after his defense makes a big stand. But getting back to Hardy, you know, he threw three scores and led their team to victory 26-24. So he's capable of bringing a team back and getting him back in the football game. That's what he needs to do right now.
So Ryan Hart on the day, 3 of 7 for 21 yards and a pick. 14-0 South Florida. This will blast it into the end zone. Underwood will take a knee there. So Rutgers has got to get something going now. Andre Hall, a 2-yard run. Johnny Jones, a 32-yard interception return. 14-0 at the 4:18 mark here in the first quarter. Now Rutgers in a hole and got to try to get out of it, led by their senior.
Yeah, the good thing, Dave, though, it's early in this football game. It's only 14-0 with 4:18 left to go in the first quarter. So come back out, ball on your 20. You know, get a couple of good runs, get a couple of completions, get this crowd back into the game, and really start over for Rutgers.
They really do, because you can hear everybody thinking in here. It's so quiet. Now they got Tyquan Underwood in here, and he's more of a runner than a thrower. Hart, they flank him wide to the right. And here's Tris Moses, and they were waiting for that play. Somehow he got out of it. It's amazing that he only lost 3 on that play, and he can hear the groans here as they lose 4.
Yeah, I don't like that call, Dave, only because you're going up against a team that has just as much or more team speed as you, and you haven't really smashed them in the mouth going back with Brian Leonard and Ray Rice since the first series. So get back to what you do best. Now you lose 5 yards, and you're in a bigger hole than what you started.
Here's what Rutgers offense ranks coming into today. That last play was made by Jason Allen, who stayed at home and turned Moses back. Here's Hart, and not much doing there. Good job by Ben Moffitt, the middle linebacker. And now this sets up a third down play. There's Patrick St. Louis. He was involved in the play as well. And South Florida going to put in its nickel package.
I think this front seven of the Bulls, they're doing a good job of just winning the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think they're beating Rutgers off the football. And this offensive line has been walking around. They've got to take charge of this and take ownership of what they need to do to get back in this game.
Third and 13 at the 17-yard line. Rutgers down two scores. They're 0 for 2 on third down. Hart, backside blitz, loose ball, picked up. Another touchdown for South Florida. Oh, brother. Jim Leavitt's club coming in here and rampaging. Terrence Royal with the pickup, and he takes it in. 20 to nothing, and they are stunned here at Rutgers.
Dave, Rutgers can't handle the front seven of South Florida.
Plain and simple.
Untouched off the blind side of Ryan Hart. Nobody in there, and it's just a Pedro Sosa's blocking down when he should be looking outside. And just an easy pickup and touchdown for the Bulls defense.
Terrence Royal. 2 yards. They got two touchdowns in a minute 26. Here's Bronson. And the kick is up and good. And South Florida, the Bulls, in their first visit to New Jersey, has silenced this crowd. 21-0, 2:52 to go.
Blind side right here. You see 77. Pedro Sosa does not come out on the defender, Jason Allen. That's a six-year senior coming off the edge. A guy that's been here since Jim Leavitt's been here practically. He did a great job of getting to the backside and getting to the quarterback. He causes the fumble right there. And then Terrence Royal just plays second base, picks up the charity hop and runs in for six.
Line side blitz, nicely done by Jason Allen. That he can run around and bring pressure. That's what Rick Kravitz was telling us yesterday, and right on the money.
Yeah, he's been through all the changes with these Bulls. They went from Division I AA all the way to the Big East Conference, and they've gone all the way out to a 21-0 lead, and you see the two takeaways resulting in two touchdowns for the Bulls. And you can see how excited they are as a team, and anybody would be excited with this lead, but they haven't played in such a long time, and they're playing so well that they want this thing to go maybe right now 4, 6, 8 quarters.
Big picture too, don't forget, if they run the table, they can win the Big East Conference.
Destiny right in front of them, and that's what Jim Leavitt said yesterday to us. You know, no one realizes this, but we can control the Big East if we can win out.
They have the game that was hurricaned out, if you will, is against West Virginia on December 3rd. Here's Foster backing up as they make the catch over his head, 5 yards deep. So very effective kicking by Justin Tichy. Here's a look at the upcoming schedules for South Florida and Rutgers, brought to you by Advance Auto Parts. South Florida has Syracuse, Cincinnati, Connecticut, and West Virginia still to come on December 3. And Rutgers has Louisville, then a week off, and then Cincinnati to close it up. And South Florida's schedule is as tough as anybody's we've seen this year.
Yeah, how about the out-of-conference teams that they've played? Miami and Penn State?
That's what they put up. They played at Penn State.
And at Miami.
And at Miami. And here's Ryan Hart again. And now penalty flag, and that's going to go against Alan Cray, who touched up on the center. Last two Rutgers drives, four plays, minus 24 yards and two turnovers.
Offside, contact, number 94. 5 yard penalty, still first down.
Well, we told you they were excited and anxious to play.
Yeah, Rick Kravitz has that defense. Causing, they will bring pressure, and they'll bring it from the edge. Usually it's Steven Nicholas, but on the fumble behind the line of scrimmage, it was Jason Allen last series.
First and 5 Rutgers. They need something going on this drive. The deepest penetration Rutgers has made thus far is the 39 of South Florida. Ray Rice running room. And nice run there. Taken out finally by Louis Gachette. 7 yards on the game, brought down by number 7. Ray Rice coming off a 21-carry, 80-yard performance last week against Navy. Had two rushing touchdowns, a 3 and a 2-yard run. And he caught a pass for 17 yards.
Yeah, and the freshman had 217 versus UConn, which was fourth best in Rutgers history.
The numbers, Rutgers must turn around immediately. First and 10 from the 32. Leonard, good hit in there. I think that was the middle linebacker coming over. Picked up 5 on that play. Patrick St. Louis, 54, Ben Moffitt there for South Florida.
See, I like this is the way they should have came out and started that last series. Just come out and play tough-nosed football. Brian Leonard knows how to do that. 7 touchdowns on the season. That's second in the Big East, and so does Ray Rice. He's only a freshman, but let him run between the tackles. And if he gets out of the outside, he can show you some speed. And Craig Versteeg coming back to his bread and butter.
Craig, the offensive coordinator, QB coach. Here's Hart with a play fake. Got time. Look at backside, throws underneath. He's got Marcus Daniels. Hit the first down, gave it up and got it back. Wow. And then he's rodeoed out of bounds by Ben Moffitt. Marcus Daniels, who's a junior out of Florida. That'll be his 5th catch of the season, a gain of 13 yards.
You have to have a clock in your head as a quarterback, and Ryan Hart used every last second to get that football outside to Marcus Daniels, because John Simmons and Tavarius Robinson made a sandwich of Hart in that offensive backfield. And as you said, Dave, he almost gave up that first down, but he did a good job of getting back to the outside and getting it close to the 50-yard line for the Scarlet Knights.
3 scores on the board for South Florida. Andre Hall, a 2-yard run, a 32-yard reception, interception return by Johnny Jones, and Terrence Royal with a 2-yard fumble return, accounting for the scores. Here's Rice, big burst up the middle. Got the first down, looking backside, and then blasted down. Leon Hart in there, taken down by Ronnie McCullough, gain of 11.
I like the attack from Rutgers in this series. They catch the Bulls in a defensive stunt and a run stunt. Watch this defensive line. Everybody's going towards the top of the line of scrimmage, going left to right, and Ray Rice rips him for about 11 yards. You love the toughness shown in this possession, being down 21-0. Rutgers trying to get back in his football game.
Rice, 5 carries, 37 yards. Here's Leonard for maybe 1, maybe 2 tops. Steven Nicholas, number 51 on the tackle. Brian Leonard, first team All-American last year by Pro Football Weekly, first team All-Big East performer. Putting up numbers again, 4th in the Big East in reception per game, in all-purpose yards, and 6th in rushing.
He's just a weapon. He's got a 31-game catch streak now intact for this game, and he can do it all. He can block, he can run, he can get out on the outside and show you those elusive moves and speed.
Winding down first quarter here at Rutgers, 21-0 South Florida. Big hole, Ray Rice. Made a man miss. Gachette, who headed further damage. First down Rutgers to the 24, gain of 14. Ray Rice has got some serious explosion.
It looks like Sam Johnson, the backup tight end, may be down, but a great job. Left side with a cut block. Mike Fladell, the sophomore, coming in to replace Jeremy Zuda at that left tackle spot. Perfect block backside.
Now the offensive line, you know, getting some confidence now.
Yeah.
Big difference.
Well, you have to feed those backs. You don't want to do those smoke and mirror plays, the reverses and the fluff on the outside, because your bread and butter is between the tackles.
Good group, too. Good size on that front line for Rutgers. Sosa, 6'5", 300. Fladell, 6'8", 318. Stapleton, 6'3", 305. John Glass is 6'5", 300. And Sammy McDonald is 6'5", 310. And this is a lot bigger ball club. And if you've been following Rutgers football for a lot of years, this is maybe its biggest O-line they've ever had.
Well, you have to set your hat on something, and you have to do something well. And it all starts with your offensive line. You're only going to be as good as you are from tackle to tackle. And, you know, Sosa and Mike Fladell, Stapleton, Glass, and McDonald, they need to carry this team, because they're a well-balanced club. They can throw it and run it. We're going to take a look at Sam Johnson down the field. He just lands on that left shoulder.
Yeah, hyperextended, looked like. Coming in trying to help out.
And that's a position, Dave. You know, we haven't mentioned Clark Harris yet. And down in this position inside the 30-yard line, you have to look for Clark Harris. He came into the game with 25 receptions. He's got a 26-game catch streak that he needs to keep intact. That's a guy, big, big target at 6'6".
This certainly has been a big change for Rutgers, because the last 3 games, Rutgers had not allowed a touchdown, any scoring, in the first quarter. And they give up 3 scores today. Foster in motion, play fake. See if they look for Harris. They're throwing out. He got ridden out of bounds. Ridden out of bounds by Steven Nicholas. And a good job by the outside linebacker, Nicholas, to ride Harris right out of bounds.
Yeah, Clark Harris trying to get on the outside on the wheel route. Steven Nicholas, good job.
And at the end of the first quarter,
that'll do it for the first quarter here at Rutgers, where South Florida is looking for its first road win, playing its first game in 21 days. And what a start, 21-0. A couple of defensive scores, and Jim Leavitt loving it.
Let's go. Get another.
Spectacular day here at Rutgers. The weather, what is this, May? It's November 6th, for crying out loud. We're not complaining, though. Sunny, some haze, mix of clouds. 64 degrees, and it may even get higher than that. Dave Sims, John Kinjemi, and our Big East crew. South Florida, two defensive scores, and they took the opening drive in, and hence they have a 21-0 lead. Rutgers trying to respond. Second down inside South Florida territory. Nice run by Rice into the secondary. He's down to the 12-yard line. First down, Rutgers. Gain of 12 yards on that play by Ray Rice. First team All-State performer, Louis Gachette, the stop for South Florida. The Rutgers trying to get back into this game.
Good job at the point of attack, the center, Darnell Stapleton. He creates a stalemate, and he created just enough of a crease for Ray Rice to bust a run off the right side.
First and 10 at the 12, first quarter numbers. Points off of turnovers are bigger. South Florida's running very effectively. Here's Rice. They slow him up. And luckily for him, he was able to hold on to the ball. You see Nicholas getting up, the linebacker. These linebackers run well. St. Louis, Moffitt, and Nicholas doing a nice job back there as we check out our Ameritrade scoreboard. And in the ACC, North Carolina, 10-7. Over Boston College. Boston College, boy, they got overmatched at Virginia Tech a couple of weeks ago.
Boy, they sure did. You saw the team speed difference between Virginia Tech and BC.
Night and day. Early on, second quarter. Then all South Florida. This is the best threat by Rutgers today. They stay on the right side. Rice slashing through inside the five. Nicely done by Ray Rice. Picks up another seven. They're starting to get a little bit of momentum here on the old line. Sosa, Fladell, Stapleton, Glass, and McDonald.
Well, they're starting to get into this game and get a little lathered up. After you're down 21 points, you have to do something offensively, and it all starts up front. They're finally moving their feet and getting a hat on a hat. Well, you'd love to see, I think you may walk into the end zone with as much pursuit and team speed as South Florida has. Ryan Hart just fakes it to Ray Rice and comes outside with an option to run and pass.
11th play of this drive. Leonard's done a good job blocking as the fullback, and Rice got tripped up that time. Terrence Royal got in there quickly. I think that little trip up of the feet, Patrick St. Louis, Johnny Jones there as well. Royal has the 2-yard touchdown on a fumble return.
This Bull defense knows how to close on the football, Dave, and you may see a crease there for a little while. They've got such great team speed, and everybody runs to the ball so well, that hole's not there for very long.
Rutgers going for it here on fourth down. They've converted 2 of 4. Good to see Sam Johnson back in the game. Play fake. They go to the flat play fake. Get it in. That's Leonard. Touchdown, but a penalty flag on the play. They throw it to their best hands guy, and that's Brian Leonard.
It looks like a hold going against South Florida.
Holding. Defense. Number 45. The penalty's declined. Touchdown.
So the hold on John Simmons, the defensive end. And they go to their best hands guy. That's Brian Leonard.
Yeah, this is what I wanted to see on third down. Again, a little quacker to the right side, but Ryan Hart does a good job of good timing, getting the football outside and just getting it close to Brian Leonard. That's the most important thing, not how the throw looks, but if it gets there on time and on target, Brian Leonard, easy six.
Jeremy Ito, 27 of 27. Make it 28 of 28. Rutgers on the board, and they needed it. 12 plays, 80 yards in 5:24. Brian Leonard caps it off with a short TD catch from Ryan Hart. Ball game on, 21-7, South Florida. Go-to guy, Brian Leonard. And it's amazing he didn't get double-teamed on that last play. Scored from a short pass from Ryan Hart. Hart's 12th TD pass, Leonard's 5th TD catch. 12 plays, 80 yards, and 524 as Mike Curtis gets ready. They kick it off. 21-7, Rutgers finally on the board. They gave up two defensive scores. First drive of the game, South Florida drove it 83 yards in 10 plays. Curtis hits a knuckleball. See if it goes out of bounds. They're going to let it go out of bounds. It does. And that was not effective at all.
Kickoff out of bounds. By rule, ball will be placed at the 35-yard line. First down.
Brian Leonard does a nice job of getting out of the backfield. Good play fake to Ray Rice and then just get it close. Look at him adjust his body and then get it squared up north and south to fight off the tackle of Stephen Nicholas to get into the end zone. He has a knack for getting into the end zone. 12 plays, 80-yard drive. Leonard, 3-yard TD reception. Rice had a great drive there, 53 yards rushing.
It's South Florida's thought's going to be here on this possession. They've run the ball very well. They've dominated. Their offensive line has been just sluggo to this point. They're keeping on the ground. Here's Hall again. And a better job by Rutgers this time. Ball came out. Ryan Neal scraping down the line. Helps make the tackle. Frierson there as well. Andre Hall, offensive MVP and playmaker of the year last year for South Florida. And Ryan Neal, he's having an outstanding campaign. First team all Big East a year ago. Third in the Big East in sacks right now. And he's the nominee for the Draddy Trophy, which is the academic Heisman Award. All those numbers that Rutgers has done in the losses. In terms of points allowed. Joe missed. Across the 40 to about the 42-yard line. Pretty good run. Neal, Chenry Lewis, Ramel Meekins all there for Rutgers. Meekins having a good year too. Fifth in the Big East in sacks and 5.5 on the campaign.
Yeah, they do a good job of running down the line of scrimmage. And Jolmas, not a small guy, so a tough guy to bring down. He's 6'3", 220 pounds out of Miramar High School in Miramar, Florida. He has a strong arm, but he's got some strong legs to boot, so he does a good job of running the football on that edge.
South Florida trying to keep this drive going. They're one of two today. Third of the Big East on the season. Jolmas looks, got a man down there. It's Jackson closing down quickly as Derek Roberson, the junior from Oakland Park, Florida. First down, South Florida, 5 yards on the pickup. Setting up that out and up, John.
Yeah, I was just thinking about the out and up myself. Pat Jolmas has hit two of those hitch routes to the outside to Amari Jackson. He does just enough to the outside to threaten him and comes back. Good timing on the hitch route. Jolmas pitch and catch easily to the outside, but you're right. Pretty soon, a little fake and throw it up, make an easy six.
Johnny Payton will be to Jolmas left. And Jackson, bottom of your screen. Nice fake. Got it out there. First down, South Florida. To the 35-yard line. Got it to Amari Jackson. 18 yards for number 18. Last 2 years, he was at Hillsborough Community College. He's out of Sarasota at the Riverview High School.
Well, I like the way he runs routes to the outside. Amari Jackson goes down and wants to push the post pattern, but comes back out. Great fake by Pat Jolmas, and just get it close. That's all that Rod Smith, the offensive coordinator and quarterback coach for the Bulls, asked. Just get it close. We've got athletes on the outside.
The name Amari Jackson will make the Louisville fans shudder. Three touchdowns against the Cardinals. Jolmas pitch, Hall outside with room. 30, first down, inside the 25 at about the 22-yard line. Got some good work from one of the wideouts.
Yeah, Jackie Chambers.
Nice job. Gain of 13. Got an old lineman down.
Might be Watson, yeah, Thed Watson, the junior out of St. Petersburg.
Amari Jackson, big performance against Louisville. And the Louisville fans covering their eyes. Look at this.
I would too. He did it all. He caught footballs on the outside. He ran reverses. He ran kicks back. It was just one of those games you didn't expect South Florida to come away with a victory, but the way they did it, Dave, it was just incredible.
This is the killer right here.
Yeah, throw it. He's probably right-handed, just did it left-handed for spite the night he was having.
Derek Carter, Those are some serious numbers. They were the team of the week after that blowout 45-14 win over the Cardinals. Up the middle, Hall, about the 20, picks up two. Pretty good play in there by Frierson, number 50. Meekins there as well.
Thompson with the tackle.
That can Jimmy, not one of the great bee killers on the planet.
You know what?
Yeah, you wave him towards me for crying out loud.
I'm trying to just keep you away.
11 carries, 77 yards for Andre Hall. How about South Florida just moved right down the field? Oh, just a little bit of movement, don't you think, Chris Carruthers?
Prior to the snap, false start, offense. Number 74, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Senior out of Clearwater, he knew what he had to do. He knew he wanted to get
it
down
left. I'm going left. I'm going left. I'm going left. Snap the ball already. Yeah, you can't hide when you're 6'3", 305.
Ryan Neal's thankful the whistle blew because he was the target. There's a penalty story. Rutgers only been tapped once. South Florida, it's about eight again. 21-7 South Florida. Bubble screen blown up. Well done. Nicely done by Corey Barnes out of Carroll City High School in Miami. He was the hero of the game at Syracuse. An INT and a punt return.
Yeah, good recognition on the outside, but Johnson, the wide receiver, is supposed to block on the outside on Corey Barnes. Totally whiffs. And Corey Barnes gets in for a big stop, and that helps with field position. That ball gets pushed back all the way to the 30-yard line in a long third down situation.
What's our favorite guy, Bob Bucher, say? Swing and a miss.
You got that right.
21-7. Here comes some pressure. Jonas hangs. Got a man down there. Caught at the 5. It'll be first and goal for South Florida. Jackie Chambers, the sophomore from Miami's Edison High School, for 28 yards.
Well, I've been impressed the way Pat Jolmus has been able to get the football close to his wide receivers and great separation. You haven't seen any of the Bulls offensive guys on the outside have to fight for catches. They've been open and they've done a great job of creating that cushion on the edge. You know, Amari Jackson's done it all afternoon, but Jackie Chambers there wide open on the corner.
Manny Collins just a little bit late. Here's Hall cutting it back and denied. No, they give it to him. He broke the play. He stuck the ball out, got a touchdown. South Florida. Smart play by Andre Hall, the senior from St. Petersburg. And Jim Leavitt's club tacks on another touchdown. It's 27-7. 2 yards on the run by Andre Hall, his second TD of the day and his eighth of the season.
Let's see if he gets this football across. Ryan Neal has him about the 1 yard line.
Broke the
plan.
Yes,
sir. Good call by the official.
And for the point after, tacked on by Kyle Bronson. South Florida Bulls with intentions to maybe take a Big East crown if they can run the table in their first year of the Big East Conference, blowing out Rutgers with 8:15 to go in the second. Our first time seeing Andre Hall, and he's more than lived up to the billing. Two touchdowns today. He just capped a 9-play, 65-yard drive in 4 minutes and 13 seconds. And Pat Jolmus, not too bad either. The quarterback with a 3rd and 18 completion to Chambers, big play. And that is Underwood watches it go out of bounds, so Rutgers will get the ball on its 35-yard line. Let's take a look now at our Hyundai cool fact. As Justin Tichu banged a few into the end zone, didn't hit that one well at all. A cool fact today, Rutgers record in November under Greg Schiano in his fifth year. Ouch.
Wow. Not good. Greg Schiano might think it's a fact, but I'm not sure how cool it is, Dave. Huh?
And I'm sure we'll hear about that the next time we visit.
Yeah. You know, you have two kickers, both guys kicking it out of bounds. I think that drives head coach nuts as well.
No question. Rutgers needs to respond. Down 28-7, a lot of time to go. Midpoint here in the second. Hart steps up, delivered, man, there, caught, first down. Stand on his feet to the 25-yard line is Trez Moses. Trez Moses for 40 yards, and that's his first catch of the day.
Now you talk about throwing the football effectively. We've talked about some that haven't looked real good. That one looked great. Ryan Hart, that ball came out with ease and a wide open Trez Moses.
30
just
consecutive,
a skinny post, Dave.
30 consecutive games now with a catch.
No help in the middle, and it's easy pitch and catch for Hart to Moses.
Each possession become critical here down this many scores. Rice pushes the pile for about three.
Rice, the ball carrier.
Carlton Williams, middle linebacker, Ben Moffitt there. Carlton, free safety.
And I just think it goes back. You kick the ball out of bounds, you get the ball on the 35-yard line. One play, now you're inside the Bulls' 25-yard line. So, you know, great field position, and Rutgers takes advantage of it, and they've got it in scoring position, and they needed a quick score to answer the 28-7 deficit.
Rice, 11 carries for 54 yards. For 70 yards, beg your pardon, for 70 yards. Second down at six, long count for Hart. Gives it to Rice, good explosion. Punishes one of the backers. And he ran right over Patrick St. Louis for six. First down for Rutgers.
Good running by the freshman, Ray Rice, who probably isn't a freshman any longer. He's done a great job of lowering his shoulder and runs right over Patrick St. Louis. We saw the Bulls, Andre Hall, do it in our open package. That's exactly what Ray Rice does, the freshman from Rutgers.
Rutgers trying to respond. Down 28-7. I give it to Rice again. Nice patience. He hangs in there, gets it to the 11-yard line. Another 5-yard carry. And setting up the play action rather well. All this inside work between the guards.
Steve, I think you called it perfectly. Good patience by Ray Rice, just hiding behind Mike Fladell, the left guard. Give him a chance to pull and get out in front of Ray Rice. But yeah, you're calling for the tight end here. You know, you want to give a little play action and either hit Brian Leonard again or look for Clark Harris. He's a big target.
Last three carries, 4, 6, and 5, the gains by Rice. Play fake, Hart got time, had time, down he goes. And that was Terrence Roy. We've seen him already at the 2-yard fumble return. He got a sack, and I'm sure now face mask called against South Florida.
We have two penalties against the defense. Face mask, 5-yard penalty. That penalty is declined. I have holding defense. Half the distance to the goal.
Now, like a 5 number he mentioned on the end. 45, probably John Simmons.
Yeah, it was a good play by Terrence Royal, the 4-year starter for Jim Leavitt's ball club, getting to the quarterback, and they wave off the face mask and get the hold. So now the Scarlet Knights get the football around the 5-yard line.
Tell you what, Rutgers has given up 2 defensive touchdowns. You know, if they don't give those up, this is matching the score right here.
Yeah.
Be an even ball game. They got a pick for touchdown, a fumble recovery for a touchdown for South Florida. 6 penalties for South Florida. Leonard gets the call at the 5, moves the pile to about the 3. They can't even bring him down.
That's where you need to do the Reggie Bush thing and start pushing the pile.
That's right.
Those guys getting in the end zone.
Well, I think before the day's over, the way both offenses are getting up and down the field, we may see some. Well, first and goal for Rutgers at the 3. 28-7. South Florida. It's been a hair pulling kind of day for Greg Schiano. First possession. South Florida takes it in. The next 2 scores come off turnovers. Hart. Fade from Moses. Got a touchdown, Rutgers. Trez Moses, 28-13. 3 yards on a connection. Ryan Hart's 2nd TD catch of the day, 13th of the season.
That's the way you go and attack the football. Watch Trez Moses go up and just grab the football, really take it away from the defender. He's up early, and as a defender, Dwan Brown has to turn his head at some point. You're on the goal line. You know the pass can only go 10 yards. You have to adjust and turn your head if you're a defender. He doesn't. Trez Moses was successful because he attacked the football.
Fourth TD catch by Moses this season. Jeremy Ito, point after. Put down by backup quarterback, actually the backup tight end. Nice job in there by Anthony Callie. Got a ball game. As Rutgers comes back. And now a two-score deficit after being down 21-0. Better weather day here in Piscataway, New Jersey. 28-14 South Florida, Big East football. And here's how it happened. It was Trez Moses caught the first play and the last play of this drive.
Yeah, good throw and good job by Trez Moses, making sure he gets 1 foot down. He got both down, just in case he's thinking about playing on Sundays.
Cortez to kick
but
off.
A good throw that time by Reinhardt inside the 5 yard line. And it gets his team, more importantly, to close that cushion to 28-14.
Big numbers there. 40 yards on a post pattern to get that drive going. Here's Cortez, not going to take as big a run up to keep it in bounds. Kicks a knuckleball, and they're going to get good field position anyway. And that was Jackie Chambers taking it up to about the 28-yard line. Look at Jackie, had a big 28-yard catch last time South Florida had the ball. Join us again next Saturday when a victory-hungry Connecticut Huskies ball club travels to the Steel City to take on the versatile Pittsburgh Panthers. The Big East game of the week, UConn versus Pitt, next Saturday at noon Eastern, only from ESPN+. Bad thing is that's our next to last game of the season.
You believe it?
No. Seems like we just started. Where was that? At Illinois was our first game.
Right.
And then of this package, it was the third game of the season. Here's Hall with room again. And a good job by Ryan Giroux coming up from the strong safety, number 43.
Giroux in on the tackle.
4 yards on the game.
What's a big stand for Rutgers defensively?
Gotta
they have
to
try to come out, and they definitely have to keep the Bulls out of the end zone, but they want to get field position and get that football back for their offense. And who's to say the Bulls have been scoring defensively? Rutgers has to come up with something defensively.
South Florida scored on the first drive, then got two defensive scores off of turnovers. Rutgers answered with a touchdown, and then South Florida drove the field again. Both teams, the last two possessions, benefiting from kickoffs out of bounds. Joel Miss gets it out of bounds. Jackson showing some speed there, huh? At 6'5". Another catch.
Pass
that's a first down for South Florida. That's a gain of 11.
Quarter with a stop.
And Jackson made the catch.
Dave, look at the cushion. Amari Jackson, a lot of respect for Amari Jackson's speed, but you have to come up and make a play. Joe Porter giving him way too much cushion. Watch him, once the DB never really turned his hips on that play, he just gave him too much cushion to begin with, and not enough help from Lewis late.
Five catches, 49 yards already for Jackson, 4:48 to go here in the second. And Jonas getting the play from the sideline. Hall gets the carry, looking to bust it. And he does, 8 yards. Nicely done, Ron Giroux. Second leading tackler on the ball club. Makes an attack. There's Ronnie out of Spring Valley, New York. Played at Herald at St. Joe's of Montvale in New Jersey.
How good is Andre Hall?
Oh, tremendous.
He just shows you that burst to the outside. He makes it look easy, a 9 yard run. It really didn't look like he gave that much effort to get outside.
14 carries, 91 yards for a Hall. And we still got 4:05 to go. Second in the Big East to Michael Bush of Louisville. And rushing. Gets the call again. Oh, whoa, good play. I thought there was going to be a big block. And then a better defensive play in there by Courtney Green. But it is good enough for first down. Tell you what. That is Frank Davis, number 68. He is a big young man, and he gets out in a hurry on the pull. 6'4", 320, born in the Republic of Panama. Born in New York City and raised in Panama. He is a good-looking performer out there. First and 10 for South Florida. The Rutgers 42. Gilmas caught from behind. Ryan Neal makes the play. He had help from Javon Thompson.
And I like what the Bulls are doing. Pat Julmus, the quarterback, is really taking the clock down, the play clock down to 2 or 1, and trying to make sure that this is the last possession of the half. They want to control this clock, and just a fake on the inside, but relentless pressure from Ryan Neal. He works off the block, and he gets some help from Deron Thompson, the middle linebacker. Good job and good excitement shown by Neal.
Courtney Denson's in the game. He's the backup quarterback. He's the slot receiver to the top of your screen. Jonas deep drop, penalty flag in the play. Jonas running and throws it away. He got taken down by Jamal Westerman, the redshirt freshman from Brampton, Ontario, Canada. There's two penalty flags. One on the far side, one on the near side.
Illegal formation offense. Only 6 men on the line of scrimmage. The penalty is declined. Third down.
So Greg Schiano going to take that 3rd and 10 against Jim Leavitt's ball club.
Westerman coming from the top of the screen. He beats the block on the outside of Watson. And then he shows you some speed chasing down Julmus from behind.
Well, Jackson's been their big guy receiver. There's Westerman. Jackson's got 5 catches already. Big 6'5" target. Johnny Payton's looked good. Let's see what Jonas does here. Screen. Oh, nice athletic play. How about the hustle by Westerman coming back to make the play? That's close to a first down as they got it to Ricky Ponton. Boy, Westerman does have some wheels. 6'3", 252. A redshirt freshman. Gain of 8 on that play.
How about the leap by Ricky Ponton? He gets out. This play doesn't look like it's going anywhere. And then you whoop right over the top. Yep. And when there's the pursuit by Meekins from behind.
Jumped over Manny Collins. And Jim Leavitt called for a measurement. Let's see. Yeah, it's close. I don't think he got it. I think we're talking 4 or 5 inches. Jim Leavitt. Spent a lot of time with him yesterday in our visit.
Great guy.
Yeah, enjoyed that.
Both these coaches, very pleasant to sit down and talk with.
Jim buying some time. Figure out what he wants to do here. He's got a 2-touchdown lead. Defense has forced a couple of turnovers, an INT return by Johnny Jones. And Royal, a 2-yard fumble return. And Joe missed having a real good day.
He's had a great day, 10 of 11. And that's the one thing we talked about, offense coordinator Rod Smith saying this is like a roller coaster for Pat. Today, he's on the right ride.
Brandon Baker, number one punter in the Big East Conference, averaging 43-4. He's got 6 career 60-yarders.
Offense, charge to the kicker, 5-yard penalty, 4th down.
So they'll take that, gives him more room to work with in terms of trying to aim to the near corner. Room work to work down a right
corner.
That
penalty is declined.
Well, he's put 8 kicks inside the 20-yard line and has had 1 block. Let's see if Rutgers comes after.
I think they may go for this. I don't know why. They're calling timeout. They may come back and go for this. And I don't blame them.
Yeah, I don't either. Up by 2.
Let's go. If I'm taking the attitude of Jim Leavitt, I want to go in. I'm going to win the game right here. I'm going to go in and I'm going to get in for 7 points and put this game away before halftime.
You got a hot quarterback and a hot running back and a hot receiver in Amari Jackson. That's a hand worth playing.
You know, if you're going to be the beast of the East and you're going to have control of your own destiny and you want to come out and you want to set the tone for the rest of the season, this team's rested. This team's hungry. And they wanted to go for this. Coming off the sidelines, you could see Amari Jackson and Andre Hall and Pat Julmus. They wanted this.
.159 to go here in the second quarter. South Florida looking at a 4th and 1. And Julmus, the quarterback, and Jackson, 18, just rip it off the chin strip. Coach, come on.
Give it to us.
Come on. Let's go to work.
This could be the start of our season right here. They've already been the Giant Slayers taking down Louisville when they were, you know, the paper champions so far of the league.
Played a good second half against Miami, played a good second half against Penn State. Coming up at halftime, stay with us, everybody, our ESPN Plus halftime report. First half highlights. We'll review Big East action and stats from this, the first half. Here comes South Florida.
Yeah, and Ryan Neal was the guy that stoned him last time in this fourth down situation.
They got one-on-one coverage top of the screen with Jackson. Fourth down, they're 0-for-1. Let's see if they go after it. They'll run it with holy slip. What kind of mark are they going to get? It's a first down.
Yeah, they gave it to him.
They gave it to him indeed. He slipped down, but it's watching the head linesman coming up, and they got the first down by probably about a half a yard.
And he would have made it easy.
And there it is, first down, South Florida. So they're trying to run that clock down and get another touchdown on the board.
See if we can get another look, Dave, to see if that knee does touch the ground.
Right there, he got the first down. He's good. He's good. Rutgers needs to stop, plain and simple. Still think they're going to go for Jackson at some point. They had one-on-one coverage. Top of the screen coming up. They run that way to Hall. A lot of running room. 25-20. First down to the 16-yard line. Andre Hall picks up another 15 yards. And that gets him over the 100-yard mark.
Good pitch on the outside, feels the pressure, and then wide open running room. Look at the move, the shake and bake to the outside. Great job by Andre Hall, just staying within himself. Gets that arm, thinking to lower the boom on Courtney Green, the freshman, just goes inside of him. And now the Bulls on a roll inside the 20. Look at those numbers.
6.6 yards a touch. Give it to Hall again. For 5 yards to the 10-yard line, the clock running down on a minute. I think head coach Rick Schiano will have a few things to say at halftime.
Well, I might throw it up right here and give Amari Jackson a chance to just go ahead and leap up for a catch. He's 6'5 on the edge, and he's got the height advantage to the top of the screen.
Here's Joe Mist. He'll keep it himself. And he gets it down to the 6. Picks up about 3.
USF has no timeouts remaining.
And they are taking this down. Third down. No huddle. Third down and about 2.
And Brian Jackson's calling for the football.
Sure is. Well, he can't get a touch. Hall, though, gets the first down. That'll stop the clock.
Yep.
But Corey Barnes is only 5'8". He's going against Amari Jackson at 6'5".
Neal with the tackle.
No huddle. And they'll spike it right there. Stops the clock at 15 seconds.
I might do it twice.
Rod Smith on the right. Wonder what he's going to call here. He's got a lot of avenues to take, that's for sure.
Yeah, Andre Hall, I mean, they've been gashing Rutgers inside the tackles, but I would throw it up. I'd give a chance to Amari Jackson to go up and get the football. Especially if Corey Barnes is to the outside, as you said, Dave. Only 5'8", going up against 6'5".
Yeah, it's got mismatch written all over. Now Rutgers is going to call a timeout. Yeah, it's amazing that we haven't seen more than. I mean, Jackson does have, what, 5-6 catches. But we haven't seen any, if you will, post-up moves by the 6'5 sophomore from Sarasota.
They've had so much success on the ground. And Coach Jim Leavitt probably just telling Pat Jormas, hey, here's your situation, 15 seconds. Everything happens a little quicker down there. We have no timeouts. The last thing you want to do if you throw a fade, make sure you get rid of the football and just give your athletes on the outside and get a chance to catch it.
On the Rutgers side, boy, they got a lot of things they have to worry about defending. Right before we talk more about that, the Ameritrade scoreboard shows Carolina, North Carolina leading Boston College by a count of 13-7. Texas. What about Texas last week? I get switching planes last week. They're down 28-0 to get to the hotel. They wind up winning the game. Amazing. And Auburn and Kentucky in the SEC locked up at 7-7 early on.
Yeah, that Texas team, how explosive are they offensively?
Yeah, they.
Which weapon would you
to
fall from today?
You haven't had a touch in a while? Let's see if we can take care of it.
I've been impressed with this South Florida ball club. I really love the way they run to the football defensively. Jim Leavitt, that's the side of the ball he comes from. But offensively, they've done a nice job up front controlling that line of scrimmage and getting Andre Hall and Amari Jackson and their playmakers to touch the football.
There it is, fade, big guy, too high, caught, intercepted. No, he's out of bounds. Oh, they knew it was coming. And the whole building knew it was coming, right?
We were calling for it, and you're right. And Pat Julmans, all you have to do is throw it up and throw it high enough, but keep it in play.
Corey Barnes caught it, but he got it out of bounds.
Yeah, the ball sails over the head, and that's not all on the quarterback. Sometimes as a receiver, you have to position your body to the ball's coming out, and in the out-of-bounds foot, it looked like the first foot that hit was out of bounds for Corey Barnes. But if you're the wide receiver here, you just have to back into this call. That wasn't that bad of a throw. Jackson has to adjust to that football.
Third down with 10 seconds to go. Guns it. No chance. Try to get it to Johnny Payton with 7 seconds left. And they're going to put the field goal team on the field here.
Yeah, if I'm the Bulls there, I go right back to Amari Jackson and give him one more chance to go up and get the football.
An extra point, more or less, from 10, 20-yard attempt coming up here for Kyle Bronson. His first attempt inside this range. Check that, it'll be his third, because it's going to be a 20-yarder. And it's up, and three more on the board for the South Florida Bulls.
And it's good.
South Florida's done some nice things here in the first half. A couple of defensive scores, a 20-yard field goal. A lot of work to do in the when Joe missed in Jackson. That's a play that they may go back to at some point.
Yeah. Cooler heads need to prevail right now. A lot
Boys
of excitement on the sidelines, and good job by the coaching staff getting in between. Saying, hey, all right, I hear you, but just put it closer to me next time. You know.
And everybody's excited because you see it's there. It's there, you can see it, there for the taking. That's part of the frustration.
And that's something that, you know, you work on it almost every day at practice. You go back and you just throw the fade route just to get that timing and know where Amari wants the football on the outside and, you know, to communicate with your quarterback, say, hey, leave it here for me so I can go up and get the football. But they straightened out their differences on the sidelines.
It didn't quite get to the level of Randy Moss and Culpepper last year, or T.O. and anybody this year.
Yeah.
Third 100-yard rushing game this season for Andre Hall. He's been a major part of it. What a drive. 16 plays, 66 yards, and 5-17. And Hall had big play, had a 15-yard run in that. Teaching 31-14 as Justin Tichy has it teed up. And he kicks a knuckleball right down the middle. Foster's going to bring it back. This will be the last play of the half. He's got an alley, and they're taken down. Penalty flag as well. If it's against the defense, that was Jamal Jenkins who made the tackle. He got a little face mask. If it's a defensive penalty, Rutgers has another play here.
And they will get another play, Dave.
Yes, indeed. Can't end on a defensive penalty.
Illegal block below the waist on the kicking tee. 15-yard penalty. Going to extend the period for one more play.
Mike Teal warmed up.
Yeah, if he didn't have that problem with his throwing arm, he might be the guy that gets it into the end zone from here.
What a day for Rutgers, coming in bowl eligible. The excitement is biggest buzz as we've ever heard here from for Rutgers. And then they come out and give up two defensive scores and go down in a 21-0 hole with 2:52 to go. There's Mike Teal. Got his helmet on, but Hart's going to throw this one deep. South Florida's going to rush four. This one coming right from midfield. Hart steps up, and they're going to run him down. Stays alive and chased out of bounds. Final play, first half. They couldn't get it down there. There was Hart, let's see, Harris, Hart, Tucker, and Moses were deep downfield to pick up a 13 yards for number 13. But 10 more points on the board here in the second quarter. Rutgers puts up 14. It's 31-14 here at the half as South Florida looks for its first road win. Halftime festivities coming up next. Lead is Scarlet Knights back onto the field here, down by the count of 31-14. Two defensive scores by South Florida really damaged the Rutgers in the first half. South Florida took the opening, took the first possession, 83 yards, 2 yard run by Hall, and then Johnny Jones, an interception return. Terrence Royal, a fumble recovery return, and 2:52 left in the game. And South Florida is up 21-0. How about South Florida? We talked about early in the game how happy they are to be back in action. The Hurricane Katrina wiped them out. And they missed the West Virginia game, and then there was a bye in there anyway. So now they are playing for the first time in 21 days. 54 days since the last home game.
And they were sharp coming out. And they started, and they did a great job offensively, defensively, and special teams. And this team has everything right in front of them, Dave. They've got the schedule remaining at Syracuse, who's down this year. Cincinnati, who's improving. At Connecticut, who has not played real well. And then West Virginia, and it all comes down to that. And if they can go 3-0 and set up that big game December 3rd, they've got it all right in front of them.
Sure do. And they'll be playing at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa for that game against the Mountaineers. There's a look at the quarterback, Pat Julmeist.
How about the half he had? 10 of 13.
Where do you sign up for that?
Yeah, 111. He had a long of 28, and he did a good job of running the football and running the option on the edge.
Julmeist started out 9 for 9, finished 10 of 13, 111. And he'll get to start the second half. And Andre Hall, his third 100-yard rushing game of the season. A buck 21 already. Ray Rice has done well, too, both at plus 6 a carry.
I was impressed with Hall at that Big East Media Day we had up in Newport, Rhode Island. What a good kid to sit down and talk with.
Looking for more of his first team All-Conference USA as Mike Cortese gets us underway, gets it 3 yards deep in the end zone. Torres Johnson will keep it right there. So South Florida will start at its own 20. Pat Julmeist, the quarterback last year, 47% completion ratio, or rate rather, at 7 touchdowns, 8 picks. This year, 5 touchdowns and 5 interceptions.
Well, that's been the knock on Pat. You know, his roller coaster, he needs to become more consistent and with his throws. And he did a nice job of putting the football in the right spot to Amari Jackson on the outside. To Jackie Chambers did a good job throwing the screen plays to Hall on the outside. So he did a good job managing the offense in the first half. But there's a long way to go.
Salute this offensive line, too. They came out immediately and set tempo. Let's see if they can do it here. They're going to throw. Julmeist. And bobbled and dropped. Johnny Payton was there. Payton was wide open. Julmeist saw him, and he's got a strong arm. One-man pattern and couldn't come up with it. Julmeist had a lot of time to deliver that football. Look at that. First four games, 3-1 record, allowed just one sack, and then flipped the coin the last two.
Yeah, they've done an impressive job of keeping Pat Julmeist on his feet and providing some open lanes for Andre Hall to run through.
Hall gets the carry. Ramel Meekins ran him down from the backside, number 60. Nicely done. He's got 11 and a half tackles for loss now. Lose 4 on that play.
Well, I blame that play on the play before. Johnny Payton needs to catch that football because you get into rhythm. You come out the first play of the half, nowhere to run on second down because you dropped the ball on first down. Ramil Meekins had enough presence of mind to run down that line of scrimmage and tackle Andre Hall before he could get rolling. And Hall came right out of the game. I'm not surprised. He looked a little banged up coming in after that play coming off the field.
Rutgers would love a turnover right here. Third and long. Julmeist surveying the field. Oh, my goodness. Throws it downfield. Throws it away. And a penalty flag late coming in. The closest receiver was Jackie Chambers, number 83. Field judge Bob Solikowski makes the call here.
Sideline warning against South Florida. That's their first point.
All right, so that'll bring on the punt team.
Jim Leavitt wanting to know, he said he's sorry about that. Looked like one of the officials may have tripped over him going down that sideline.
Well, Brandon Baker has a 68-yard punt to his credit this season, second only to Syracuse's Brendan Kerner. Willie Foster has a TD return to his credit. Let's see what happens here. And this is the first punt. Somebody might have got a piece of it. I'll say one thing, it went straight up in the air. And it takes a Rutgers bounce. So it doesn't get past midfield. Hang time of 4-4 on a punt that carries 27 yards.
And this is what South Florida did earlier in the season against Pittsburgh at Pittsburgh, because they totally dominated the first quarter. In that second half, they turned the football over, made mistakes. And now, right now, they're giving Rutgers in this offense, who has a lot of options offensively, great field position in their own territory.
Well, the next catch that Clark Harris makes will be his first of the day, the tight end.
He's got a 26-game catch streak to try to keep intact.
See if they find him on this possession. Hart's going to play fake, got a little bit of time. Throws, and Moses makes the catch, gain of 8. Nice pickup. And he's brought down. Carlton Williams got him. Carlton, the free safety, number 32.
That was a nice job by Ryan Hart, stringing this play out, and he was pursued by Kleibert on the outside, but he does a good job just getting a catchable ball, hitting him in stride, and Trez Moses runs through the catch. Looks like he banged up his left wrist possibly on the play.
Not good. Third catch, 51 yards, second and short. Ball at the 34-yard line. Take that for 33. Ray Rice got it in Moore. Can he get to the outside? Banging down to the 22. First down, Rutgers. Boy, he punished the DB. I think it was Williams. It was. Carlton Williams got punished, the freshman from Valdosta, Georgia.
Good blocking up front. There was not a whole lot of running room, but Ray Rice, only 5'9", just needs a crease. Breaks the arm tackle of Ben Moffitt, and then, as you said, Dave, runs right over Carlton Williams. In deep into the Bull secondary.
First and 10, Rutgers. Down 31-14, just underway here in the third quarter. Toss play to Rice. Got help to the edge. Nicely done to the 11. Another first down for Rutgers. Scarlet makes in a roll. Mike Jenkins makes the tackle in a 12-yard gain. The Rutgers coming out with an attitude right now. Just get everybody out and hit something.
Well, they got the edge in a hurry. And you can see all the red jerseys waiting to put a hat on someone wearing a white jersey. Good open field tackle that time by Mike Jenkins. But two back-to-back runs by Ray Rice and Brian Leonard out in front of Rice, doing an excellent job blocking for Romeo, who has 15 rushes for 106 yards.
This is where they like to make it BLT, Brian Leonard time. He gets the ball here. And they were waiting for him that time. Maybe back to the line of scrimmage. Good job in there by Patrick St. Louis, the outside linebacker, number 54.
Well, watching Rutgers this season, they like to go high-low here. They like to put Clark Harris and then Brian Leonard to the same side of the field after play action. Greg Schiano likes to go to guys he can trust in this situation. Well, so let's see if they go to that short side or to the left side.
Well, they got the left side. There's Harris along with Marcus Daniels and Leonard on the wing. Toss play Rice behind that grouping and run down from behind by Ben Moffitt, the middle linebacker. Moffitt shot in there, and that was one of the few times it looked like Rice might have been impatient. He's been a pretty patient runner, letting people set up their block, and that time didn't look like he gave his guys a chance, as much a chance as he has in the past.
Yeah, there was a little bit of a crease that he ends up taking, and really a good play by Ben Moffitt, cutting through the offensive line and getting to the ball carrier.
Ben's forced four fumbles on the season. That's best on the club. Third down and goal. Ball at the 8-yard line. Hart's going to throw. steps up, nothing there, looking and taken down. Taken down. Terrence Royal. Make that Willie McCullough, Ronnie McCullough in there, number 58. And that'll bring on Jeremy Ito and the field goal team.
When Clark Harris ran an in route on that play, and you know Ryan Hart would love to have this one back. Watch Hart misses Clark Harris on the in route. He's wide open. He has leverage on Johnny Jones. Watch him get to the inside of the linebacker. Here's the throwing lane right here, and Hart was looking to go underneath to Sean Tucker. Never stood with his tight end long enough to find him.
South Florida calls a timeout. Jeremy Ito will be looking at a 29-yard field goal. 4 for 4 in this range on the season. He's hit 11 of 18. Anthony Kelly is the holder. Came into Rutgers as a quarterback. Now playing a reserve tight end and holder. Think they put on a little something here, John?
I don't know. You got to get points while you can. You're down 31-14, so you'd like to take the points and then get back on defense and go three and out like you started the second half. And Jeremy Ito, if you wipe away the first game he had against Illinois, Dave, he's having a terrific season.
And number two in field goal percentage at 61.1% to Josh Cummings of Pitt. Third in Big East kick scoring and number one in, he's hit the most amount of PATs on the season.
What, did he miss four in the opener?
Yeah.
Other than that, he's been very solid.
31-14, going to make it a two-touchdown game here. Just inside the left hash. Boy, did they get quiet here. It's almost like watching you putt. Nice snap, put down by Callie. Nice job, and then bang through by the judge, Jeremy Ito.
Yeah, the big difference is they cheer after the kick. They're still silent when I putt afterwards.
Third quarter action, Rutgers on the board here. 31-17, Ito with a 29-yard field goal. Let's see if Rutgers can get a stop or if South Florida can keep on rolling. Could be considered a W for the South Florida Bulls, holding Rutgers to just a field goal there. Two score game right now, 31-17. Dave Sims and John Kinjemi with you, Big East football. Next week, well, four for South Florida. Game could turn right here. Jomist in trouble. Throws to Jackson, makes the catch, loose ball, incompletion. Rutgers is forced to three and out. And the fans can feel it. So I apologize for our technical difficulties. We're back on the air here. That was a third down pass. Jomist tried to hit to Amari Jackson.
We talked about that, Dave, how important Rutgers defense to come back out and go three plays and out, try to get that field position again for their offense.
First punt went 27 yards for Baker. Willie Foster has a touchdown to his credit, 71 yards. And this one, an end over end, got return written all over it, but then the gunner did a good job down there. How about that play? That was a fine play by Trey Williams on the low line drive kick, a 33-yard punt. Hang time of only 2.8 seconds. Did not hit that one well.
But again, Dave, this Rutgers offense and Greg Schiano, they're going to have terrific field position for Ryan Hart to maybe take a shot on first down and go down the field. Trez Moses back in the game, maybe a little pitch and go or something. You want to get a one-on-one to the outside. You've got Moses and Tucker that have an opportunity.
Harris and Moses, now Leonard all on the right side. Here's your play fake. Going outside. Got a man there, Harris. He overthrew him. He was dead wide open at the 38-yard line. Covering on the play, the outside linebacker, Stephen Nicholas, was in the vicinity. But Harris was wide open.
Yeah, and Ryan Hart knows it. He's the first guy that knows it. He shrugged his shoulders, dropped his head, said, I missed my one of my favorite targets, wide open down the field. And it's been a target that they needed to get to a little bit sooner than the third quarter.
They haven't hit him. He's not caught a pass yet. Second down play. Rutgers at its own 45. Rutgers with a 29-yard field goal to its credit here in the third quarter. And Rice for a couple.
Rice, the ball carrier.
Good play inside by Allen Craig. Gain of two, Craig number 94.
Yeah, Rick Kravitz, the defensive coordinator for the Bulls that time, sending Patrick St. Louis trying to time up the snap count. They did a good job to the short side of the field to hold that run to 1 yard.
Well, we are back up, and we apologize for our technical difficulties. A three and out by South Florida on that last possession to set up Rutgers right here. 27-yard punt. Now Rutgers looking at a third and long. Here comes the blitz. Hart hangs, fires. Ball in the air. It's intercepted. It's intercepted and going down the sideline. It's Terrence Royal. Royal fumbles the ball out of bounds, but it's going to be South Florida ball. So Royal gets his second turnover of the day. Terrence Royal, a senior out of Wharton High School in Tampa, Florida.
Yeah, and Rich Kravitz, the defensive coordinator, met him about the 2-yard line celebrating off the field of play. But Terrence Royal, the second defensive turnover for him today. Got the ball stripped from behind by Sean Tucker, but this defense now, Greg Schiano telling him on the sidelines, hold him to at least a field goal opportunity.
22 yards on the return. Here's where you look for that fade. Take advantage of Amari Jackson's 6'5" height against a 5'8" Corey Barnes. This got fade written all over it at some point, if not here, at some point during this possession. First and 10, South Florida at the 25, and they run Ricky Ponton. Good spin jab, and he's taken down with a hard hit. That's Courtney Green, gain of six.
Hart dropping back and just wants to dump it down low. A ball should have been caught. Goes off the helmet of Moses right into the arms of Terrence Royal. And you're going to see from behind, Tucker, number four there, strips the ball but pops it out. And on that previous play, Courtney Green comes up, the freshman from New Rochelle, New York, with the tackle. But, boy, these Bulls running backs, they go downhill.
First hit. I mean, the yards after contact, very impressive today. Here's Hall. Had nothing there and still comes away with a yard, maybe 2 yards. Devron Thompson makes the tackle.
Yeah, Dave, you mentioned a good point. It's those hidden yards that the Bull backs have been able to come up with after first contact. These guys aren't that big physically. I mean, Andre Hall goes 5'10", 205, and Ricky Ponton, 5'11", 215. But look at the results. Hall today, 21 rushes for 119 yards. And look at the average, 5.7. A great job with the average and two touchdowns.
Third and short. Third and two at the 17. That drill miss. And the Bulls with South Florida. In this direction. And Chenry Lewis makes the tackle. They had to get across the 15-yard line. And
wait, there's some
spot. He's short.
I think so. I agree with you. Another situation where you take the three or go for it. And the Bulls have done it twice today and gone for it. I think you bring your big, you bring your Bulls out and go for it.
I hear you. Start the play clock, and they're going to send in a play. It's fourth and short. They're going to bring in Cedric Hill. South Florida one of two today on third down. Any time in the play clock. And Jomas got it easily. Going behind his left guard, and he's their money guy. Frank Davis, John Miller. Those are two big, strong young men. Frank Davis, number 68, is 6'4", 320. And he's been a road grader all day.
Is he,
John
is he
Miller's the center.
Is Frank the gentleman that bench presses like St. Pete and Clearwater at the same time?
500 pounds bench is like it's nothing. That is some serious poundage.
Some big guys up front.
First and 10 at the 14. Good look at Pat Jomas. Give it to Hall, looking for room. He found the crease. And jumping on the pilers, Courtney Green, break it up.
Dave, I've been really impressed with the way Hall glides along the line of scrimmage, but he doesn't lose any of that speed. Once he decides to turn up and find a crease, he's at top speed.
Second down and seven.
Luis Rivas made that tackle. Gain of three for Andre Hall, having an outstanding day. 3-0, look at that. When they rush for 200 yards or better, and they're at a buck 83 now. Short side of the field, top of your screen, Amari Jackson at 6'5" against 5'8", Corey Barnes. I'll keep it on the ground, up the middle. And 91, Ryan Neal makes the stop. Brian looks like he's headed to another first team all Big East season, having an outstanding year. Third in the Big East in sacks, team leader in sacks, 17 best 20 quarterback carries. He's been marvelous all year. Sets up a third down and four, under 5 minutes to go here in the third. 4 out of 10 is what South Florida has done today. Rutgers shows blitz, they run the option, pitch it back, Hall to the edge. And he's inside the five, and looks like he does have the first down. First and goal for South Florida. Deron Thompson is there along.
Thompson with the tackle.
Derek Roberson making the tackle for Rutgers.
Andre Hall, one of the best backs we've seen all season long. Watch him make Ron Garalt miss at top speed. Just lift the right arm, just slips him to the inside, gets help from Thompson on the inside with the tackle, but just so impressive how he can make someone miss in the open field without breaking stride.
Here's Hall's second effort. He's in. Touchdown. South Florida Bulls. And another score on the board. A 2-yard run by Andre Hall. His third 2-yard run of the day. And this crowd has been quieted again.
Yeah, number two goes 2 yards for six. His effort inside the five has been phenomenal, Dave.
Yes, it has been. Deuce is wild today here for South Florida. And penalty flag, whistle blow that dead. 25 carries, 133 yards.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense. 74, 5-yard penalty, repeat the try.
Chris Carruthers, the junior, make that the senior from Clearwater. Well, that'll back up Kyle Bronson just a little bit. He's a freshman from Tampa. Walk on last year, redshirted. And now the starting kick. 6'1", 190 out of Wharton High School. And it's blocked. And that'll keep it right there. So 37-17. And Ryan Hart and the Rutgers Scarlet Knights have a lot of work to do. Again, break 14 coming up for the stations down the line. Back to Piscataway right after this timeout. Fumble return for touchdown. Convert that into an 8-play, 25-yard drive and 4:06. Andre Hall's third 2-yard touchdown run. Point after was blocked. 37-17, that's where we are now. Rutgers scores a Hart to Leonard pass, Hart to Moses, and a field goal by Ito. Here's the kick. Underwood's going to take it at the 4. Oh, that tackle. There's one guy, two guys broke up
Underwood
the wedge. And that was a difference maker right there. Jeremy Burnett. Take a break here from Piscataway. 4:11 to go in the third. And it's a 20-point South Florida lead. Here's a look at Mike Teal. Might he get some action today? Suffering from a shoulder problem. Don't forget next week, Saturday, we've got the University of Connecticut Huskies. They're dying to get a road win, and they go to the Steel City, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Take on the Pitt Panthers. It's our Big East game of the week, UConn and Pitt. Next Saturday at noon Eastern, only from ESPN+. Hart gets it to Leonard, and a loss there. Steven Nicholas with a quick tackle there. It's like they give him a yard, maybe two.
Yeah, Steven Nicholas, Rick Crabb was raving about him yesterday when we spoke with him about being a playmaker, and he's a force. They like to bring him a lot on second and third down, but on that play, just goes east and west and covers up Brian Leonard like a glove.
Again, at this stage, I'm still amazed Clark Harris has no catches, and they've only thrown to him once. Tight end, going to keep it on the ground, Ray Rice. Going to keep his balance. Took a hit, kept on going. Ran through Johnny Jones, number 6. First down, Rutgers. Across the 35 to the 36.
Nice run by Ray Rice, but Craig Versteg, the offensive coordinator, to our left. At some point, he's going to have to push the envelope down the field, and you know you like to get Trez Moses or Willie Foster, Sean Tucker, somebody, Clark Harris, involved in this offense, but Ray Rice doing a nice job on second down, but at some point, you got to take it down deep.
15 yards on the pickup. Blitz coming from the outside. They pick it up. And then taking down, almost taking it. Here's Rice for about five. As Hart hit pressure from his right, then he had it from his left and was able to get rid of it.
You know, and sometimes in going deep opens up other things. If you can push the defense of the Bulls off the line of scrimmage, you can hit these checkdowns and get a lot of quick yardage that way. So it's not necessarily having the ball go downfield, but sometimes the illusion of the ball going downfield, you can open up everything else underneath.
Ben Moffitt made that last tackle for the Bulls. 2:34 to go. And counting. Third quarter. They run it. And they went right where the blitzers were. And a first down again. Rice into South Florida territory at the 47. Penalty flag coming in late. It's like they got to separate Trey Williams and Marcus Daniels. Gain of 14 on that play. A dead ball foul, personal foul. It is against South Florida, so that'll tack on. At some point, don't you think,
after
guys?
After the play was over, dead ball, personal foul, hands to the face. Number 21 defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Tell you what, a good part of your offense anymore is the beta DB, because a lot of these DBs aren't, you know, they got to stand up for their manhood and cost the team 15 yards.
Yeah, but Dave, this hasn't changed in 100 years of football. The second guy is always going to get caught. I mean, I don't know how many times you have to say it, but the second guy in is always going to get caught. And that time, a bad decision by the sophomore Williams.
31-17, 138 yards of penalty. My goodness. Sprint out by Hart and throw it back. Got Harris on a convoy, too. Fredell with a block. He's at the 10, 5. Harris is to the 1 yard line. 31 yards. And it should set up a six spot here for Rutgers.
And Clark Harris is hurt. They finally get the football to Clark Harris on the screen. Watch Ryan Hardy takes everybody in white jerseys over with him to the short side of the field. Goes back to his tight end. A great effort by Patrick St. Louis. He's the guy that comes from behind to keep Clark Harris out of the end zone, but it looked like he hurt his right shoulder. Let's see, let's take another look, see if this football crosses the line.
Fans are erupting to our left, and it looked like he may have broken the plane on that replay. And trying to stretch it out. Tim Jones is the injured player for South Florida as they check out Clark Harris's elbow. Let's see, stretch.
That's a touchdown. I think that's a touchdown.
He broke the plane.
His knees were on Patrick St. Louis, so they never hit the ground.
He broke the plane. That should be a six.
Take one more look. You see 54 St. Louis going along for a ride. Clark Harris never touches the ground.
His knees don't.
The hand does not count. Right there, it's close. That's close. I think that's six.
The previous play is being reviewed.
That should be a touchdown. I don't think there's any question about it. It is being reviewed.
Good to see Tim Jones coming off the field, the senior from Lakeland. Another big play guy in that interior line for the Bulls. Another look. Clark Harris would not be denied. He starts that drag about the 4 yard line. I think that ball's across the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, no question.
Johnny Jones gets there late, number six for the Bulls, to keep Clark Harris's body going towards the sideline. But right here, that hand does not count. That ball breaks the plane right there.
Big East instant replay designed to allow specific types of officiating calls to immediately be reviewed and corrected during all conference games. And plays governed by sideline, goal line, end zone, and in line are reviewable. Scoring plays, reviewable. And this one qualifies. And
we've got a winner.
Yeah. You like the, as an ex-player, do you like it? You like the replay?
Yeah, I do. I like it because as long as it doesn't stall the game, you know, for an extended period of time. I think if you get it right, everybody can walk away saying, yeah, it was the right call. You know, you took time to do it, but it's the right call. And if this turns around, and it should be a touchdown.
So it's either 31-yard gain or 32-yard touchdown catch. Ryan Hart, 11 of 18, 124, two touchdowns, two picks, and a fumble. Be surprised if this is not a touchdown. That would make it.
After review, the play stands as called. First down, 1 yard line.
Well, the Rutgers fans are upset. They're at the 1 yard line. They got four cracks at it.
Yeah, but it is November and we are at Rutgers, Dave.
Leonard. No sign. He didn't get in. South Florida hell. They had to know it was coming to Leonard too, because he's the guy. He's the good hands guy on this ball club down here.
I'd be upset too, because I want to take a touchdown as soon as I can get one.
That's right. Preserve some time too.
Yeah.
Steven Nicholas makes the tackle. Oh, the agony for these Rutgers fans. 31-17. Gotta have a touchdown. Gotta have it if you're Rutgers and Greg Schiano. Clock running down near the end of the third quarter. Do a little waggle here. Give it to Leonard. Leonard, he's in. Touchdown.
Now the cannon. They're on time now on the hill.
But Brian Leonard, touchdown catch, and now a touchdown run.
Now, Brian Leonard, 6'2", 235. Watch him go for his 13th touchdown of the season. Watch him elevate right behind Stapleton, the center. Great job of getting into the end zone. Would not be denied.
His 8th rushing touchdown. Here's Ito for the big extra point. Good snap. Cali puts it down, booted through. 37-24. And for the department of, hey, you never know. Still got 15 minutes and another 109 left in this quarter still to go. The stranger things have happened. Seven plays, 81 yards, and 302 for Rutgers.
Good job by Darnell Stapleton, the center. He does a good job of just creating a stalemate and a crease. And that right side of the line, the Bulls defense just collapses to let Brian Leonard go over the top. That's a football player right there.
Mm-hmm. Got first team all conference written all over him again. We're thinking now for your Jim Leavitt in South Florida on offense. What do you tell your offensive crew to do?
Well, you need to go back to that offensive line and say, hey guys, we were dominating this first half running the football. And we were moving the chains and we were eating some clock up. So the offensive line, you know, for the Bulls, they have to come back out and do something. And Rutgers, they did a good job coming out after halftime and establishing the line of scrimmage with their offensive line. But if you're wearing white today and you're South Florida, you have to come out now and go back and establish that 1-2 punch, the easy pitch and catch on the outside for Julmas and the running of Hall.
Rice had a couple of big plays in that drive, 15-yarder and a 14-yard run. Here's Mike Cortez. Kicks it off. This will be returned from about the three chambers. Head of steam, found the hole, got hit. Taken down at the 28-yard line.
Chambers on the return.
So he got taken down in there by Peter Turbidov. Peter, number 97, freshman from Union, New Jersey. Scoring drive, Leonard caps it off a 1 yard run. 81 yards, seven plays and 302. Harris had the big 31-yard gain down to the 1 yard line. 37-24, late third. South Florida in the lead. Andre Hall gets the carry, taken down. Rutgers looking for another three and out. As Patrice Studovic makes the tackle, number 88.
Good line stunt by Rutgers. Everybody going to the right side. Looked like they knew they were in the offensive huddle that time. Good call, good pressure on the edge by head coach and defensive coordinator Greg Schiano.
About a half yard gain on that one. Winding down here in the third. Rutgers will kill for another three and out. Right. Hall for three. Neal, Meekin, they're all there. Sturdivant there as well, and Devron Thompson. That's going to do it for the third quarter.
You can feel, Dave, this Rutgers crowd coming back into this game, and they're getting excited by this defense.
37-24. Stranger things have happened, folks. Back with the fourth quarter coming up. Start of the fourth quarter, 31,131 on hand here at Rutgers Stadium. John Congemi, Dave Sims here. Glad you could join us. I think we have a furious finish in front of us, Coach. 37-24, South Florida.
Where's Amari Jackson in this early in his fourth quarter?
Didn't get a touch in the third. Joe Miss throws. Three and out. He was there, and it would have been good for first down. It would have been good for a first down, the first time they've thrown at Jackson this half. And there's Rutgers scoring by the quarter.
Yeah, that's the quarter we're talking about right now, though, Dave. Only 19 points.
Yeah.
And they've given up 52.
Willie Foster chomping at the bit. He wants to return this punt.
They were close to blocking the last punt, so I wouldn't be surprised if Marcus Faison doesn't get close to this one.
Baker going to try to rip one. Hits it fairly well. Nothing great. Keeps Foster's hands off. Let's see where it goes out of bounds. Where do they mark it?
Bad kick.
They're going to mark it. Boy, the side just keeps walking up the field. Wow. This is going to be a nothing punt here. Right there. Oh, my goodness, to the 42-yard line. So that punt covering all of 25 yards. He has a 27-yarder to his credit earlier. So Rutgers has good field to work with here. 27, 33, and 25, the punts today by Brandon Baker, the number one punter in the Big East, not having a good day.
Well, Greg Schiano in this offense cannot complain about having a field position early in this second half, and perfect time again. They tried it again after a change of possession, but play action and maybe go over the top here.
There's a play fake. There's a reverse action, and again, staying home. Great play. Going to be a hold coming up. That's going to be against Rutgers. Second time they've run that play from that very same spot. Ronnie McCullough blows up the play. Ronnie out of Tampa's Hillsboro High School. He stayed at home. He did his job.
It's one thing to have a bad play, Dave, but to make a bad play worse and make a bad decision on the reverse, Pedro Sosa looked like he didn't do a good job. It was either...
That play didn't work the first half.
No, it looked like the same play from the first half.
And from the same spot on the field, too.
Just a reverse, everybody flowing right, and then the handoff to Moses coming back. There's the block right here, we're gonna see it. Right there.
Yeah, there it is.
Just a bad decision, you don't do that. If you see his numbers, pull off. At least shield him, you don't have to extend your arms, you can just stand there.
Block in the back, number 77 offense. That penalties declined, second down.
Sure, I understand that, because look at the loss. They lost about 5 yards on the play. Well, why give him another down? So now Great Channel and company got to come up with something. They lose 6 officially.
Yeah, I think the reverse is officially out of the Rutgers offense after seeing it today.
I think the word you're looking for is delete. Leonard in motion. Hart's going to throw it. Going deep, middle, wide open. Moses is got it. First down, Rutgers, and tacked on a face mask. He beat Mike Jenkins and beat him badly. Big numbers there. 44 yards for Trez Moses from Ryan Hart.
And Moses is down. That was violent. The right hand came in from Mike Jenkins. May have got inside the face mask of Trez Moses. Good throw by Ryan Hart. A great catch. But a personal foul. Going against Mike Jenkins.
Glad to see Moses be able to get up.
Watch the strike down the middle, but watch the right hand of Jenkins come in around the right side of the face mask right there.
Oh, yeah.
And ripping it down.
And the Rutgers fans back in it now. And South Florida taking some body blows. 37-24, plenty of time, just underway here in the fourth. It'll be first and goal at the nine.
What a nice route by Trez Moses, pushing Mike Jenkins to the outside, knowing he's got no help to the middle of the football field, and a good timing throw by Ryan Hart.
11 penalties for 153 yards for South Florida.
How about Ryan Hart coming back in the second half?
Yes, he has been very effective, Ryan Hart. Rice and Leonard in an I formation. Rice gets it, tries to bounce it. Wow, he carried a guy. How about that play? Little piggyback. Takes it down to the 5-yard line.
Got a little rodeo show going on here, Dave.
Look at this.
The Bulls named Ray Rice and Johnny Jones on the ride. We'll give him a 7-2, I think, on that day.
20 for 141 for Ray Rice. Rutgers down 13. Roping and copping.
That's not true.
That'll be coming up a little bit later in our program. Y'all stay tuned. We'll waggle back the other way. He's getting a nice block, Sam Johnson. But Hart couldn't get to the end. Sam Johnson did a great job, 85, trying to clear the way. If Hart could have planted and cut back, he might have been able to get it.
Yeah, I think the problem Ryan had was he didn't make a decision. He kept it out in limbo for too long. Right here, you have to push the line of scrimmage and attack the line of scrimmage. He's going laterally, and that makes the defense, gives him time to catch up. If you can push it towards the line of scrimmage, you force the defense to do something, either come up and attack you, and you can dump it over the defensive head of the defender. So, you know, Ryan Hart just needed to attack that line of scrimmage.
So that Nicholas having a great day. Third and goal, 0 for 6 on third down today for the Scarlet Knights. Over the middle, touchdown, Clint Harris. 37-30, a 4-yard hookup. Ryan Hart leading them back again.
Greg Schiano doing his part on the sidelines, but he must have given a great talk at halftime, because this is a different team than spotted the Bulls all those points in the first half.
Wonder if he peeled some paint with his halftime delivery.
I think just staring at the wall could have happened at halftime.
Here's Ito. Rutgers is down 21-0. Point after critical. Ito. It's good. 37-31. Hello. Hart's third TD pass, the second catch of the day for Clark Harris. And we have got a ball game with plenty of quarter left. Don't go anywhere. A 6-point contest. Back, everybody. The sun's shining on a fun day here in Big East football. Dave Sims, John Kinjemi. Rutgers down 21-0. Fought back to 37-31. Ryan Hart with his third TD catch. Clark Harris getting the fans riled up and ready to go here. His first TD catch of the day.
Well, Hart was looking left the entire way and finally finds a crease for his tight end. Good catch by Clark Harris.
I think there'll be some violence on this kick right here by Mike Cortez. Keeps it in bounds. Boy, hit a line drive and it's cut. Chambers gonna bring it out, 2 yards deep. Uh-oh. And Chambers does an outstanding job to get the ball to the 30-yard line. Nicely done. Jason McCourtney makes the tackle as we check out our Guinness game summary. Points off of turnovers. Look, boy, South Florida's done a fabulous job. Andre Hall, 136 and 3 touchdowns. Rice has beaten that, except he hasn't scored. Trez Moses has big numbers as well. Second half yardage, Rutgers 151-30 for South Florida.
And there's more to come, Dave.
Only 15 yards in the second half for Hall, Amari Jackson. Joe missed. Taken down by Ramil Meekins. Rutgers is thinking three and out right here. Andre Hall just a little bit pumped up, and Ramil Meekins in on that stop as well. And right before the kickoff, Andre Hall doesn't want to put up with any more. He wants his team to get fired up, getting in his quarterback's face. There's a leader there, the senior from St. Petersburg. big difference second half. Rutgers fans coming to full roar here.
Well, the problem, Dave, is they haven't been able to throw the football effectively on first down.
You bet. Second down and nine. Here's Gilmas. Rolling, got time. He's got the tight end. And meanwhile, he had S.J. Green running a post with room to spare deep down the middle.
Well, the problem is South Florida's got it backwards in the second half. They have to throw on first down because Rutgers is crowding the line of scrimmage. And then on second down, you can fit your running game in. And what a tale of two halves. He started 9 for 9 to open the game, over 100 yards. Since then, only 1 for 9 for 10 yards. So that's that roller coaster ride that Rod Smith, the offensive coordinator and quarterback coach, when talking about Pat, said needs to be more consistent. And this is an ongoing process.
Jim Leavitt's club, 5 of 12 on third down. Rutgers rushes 4. They set up the screen. Downfield. Did he get it? Looks like he's short.
Late flag, too, Dave.
Johnny Payton makes the catch on the far side. And 6'5 sophomore.
I think that's going against a frustrated Andre Hall.
And they'll do that field. Offense, number 61.
John Miller, the center. So if they, Greg Schiano out on the field to make the decision.
Here's your center right here. Let's see if we can take a look and see when the ball's thrown. You see him walking forward into a light jog, so he must have been downfield. There he is, a good 10 yards downfield. He was ahead of the pass reception, I think.
Man. Cedric Hill on the far side. Now Rutgers with a touchdown ties it. Willie Foster with the sunshine in his face looking to get this next punt.
And Baker's punting has been less than spectacular. 3 punts. Look at the average. Only 28 yards.
Willie Foster shielding the sun. Baker looking to rip one here and needs it.
They did get a piece of it.
Full layout would have got the full block. It's amazing. South Florida still comes away with a positive play as the ball goes inside the 20. Who was in there to block
that
it?
That may have been the best punt of the afternoon. I think Glenn Lee was the guy on the edge.
39 yards, much of it on the roll. Should have had a block. Oh, he was right there, Joe Porter. This was once a 21-0 South Florida lead. 21-0 after 1, 31-14 at the half, 37-24 through 3, and now Rutgers in business here. They give it to Ray Rice, and Ray's next milestone is going to be 200 yards. That'll get him over 150, close to 150. Picks up 6 right there. And Steve Nicholas makes the tackle, the outside linebacker. And that is remarkable. Look at that. Total yards by the half.
It's been all Rutgers. You know, Ray Rice, 217 against UConn. That was 4th best in Rutgers history. He's well on his way to that today.
Hart, 13 of 21, 72. With 3 touchdowns and 2 picks. Rice up the middle. Ran through the first tackle. That was Patrick St. Louis and brought down another close to first down yardage. Ben Moffitt, the middle linebacker, finished him off.
Dave, we talked about yards after initial contact and talking about Andre Hall in the first half. Ray Rice doing the same thing here in the second half. He was hit, you know, as soon as he broke the line of scrimmage, he was able to get an extra 2-3 yards. And Craig Versteeg, the offensive coordinator, feeling a little bit better about chomping that gum now in the fourth quarter, only down 6 and having a chance to put a drive together for Greg Schiano's team.
Rice, 22 carries, 149. Looking at a 3rd and short. Hart going to throw it. In trouble. Going to run it. Blown up. Football recovered by South Florida. And it's recovered in there by John Simmons, the senior defensive end from St. Petersburg. Ryan Hart, never been a strong runner. Didn't put it away, and it banged out, and that's a killer. And that pretty much tells the story right there from a Rutgers perspective.
And Ryan Hart still down. He took a shot, looked like from Steven Nicklaus, as well as Terrence Royal, excited on the Bull sideline. But Ryan took a shot on that right side. That ball, you know, Dave, in a situation like that, the disruption of timing in the pass offense, the ball should be gone. And when it doesn't happen and you hold on to the football, bad things happen. You know, you almost want to throw that one away and just go ahead and punt.
And with that in mind, here's our Pontiac game-changing performance, and this is a killer right here.
Might have been Richard Kleber, yep, as well on that big hit.
Number 76, unloaded, the 6'1", 295-pounder from Edison High School in Miami. Right, bang, right there. And he had help from Nicklaus.
Yeah, Nicklaus on the bottom and Kleber on top. But again, another big turnover by this Bulls defensive unit.
And Ryan Hart, right, now Mike Teal nursing a sore shoulder. See him wincing a little bit. Got to get warmed up. Now Rutgers defense really needs to come up large from the 28-yard line, and if you're South Florida, you've got to put the ball in the end zone.
You've
got to
go at your playmaker on the outside. Amari Jackson, throw on first down, run on second.
He's got a 5'8 corner on. They run with Hall, trying to bounce it outside. Tucked down from behind. Glenn Lee with help from Frierson making the tackle.
Now, and you've been able to read the mind of the offense of South Florida in the second half. They've run on first down, so all Rutgers is doing is crowding the line of scrimmage.
If you're Corey Barnes, you got to be thinking, it's got to be coming. It's got to be coming.
Sooner,
I mean,
or
they got to be alley-ooping me sometime.
And they've only tried it once,
it's
Dave,
amazing.
And it was a bad decision by Amari Jackson with his body. But if you're on the outside and you have press coverage, I'm going to the 6'5 guy out of Sarasota.
They got Barnes on an island. They run it with Hall. Breaks a tackle. Second guy gets him, Glenn Lee. Boy, I don't understand this. You got a 6'5".
And he's calling for it, Dave.
I don't blame him. He's 6'5 and a 5'8". You figure minimum your 50-50's looking good, right?
Yeah, Jackson's calling for the sidelines, telling him what to call. Call my number, because I'm clearly got the advantage on the corner.
I figured by this time, John, as we got ready for this game during the week, I figured by now he'd have 9-10 catches, right?
Well, they've got him to the short side of the field, but they missed two golden opportunities on first and second down.
Here's a third down and long. Joe Porter's on him now. Looking that way, throwing that way, caught! Down the sideline, first down, Amari Jackson. And Porter gave him a ton of cushion, 13 yards, the yield for South Florida.
Sometimes you have to speak up and call your own number, and that's exactly what Amari Jackson did, because no one's been able to cover him all afternoon. He's had 5-6 yards of cushion, even in press coverage. The defensive backs have been running off, and that time Joe Porter runs off, and Amari Jackson makes the easy catch.
Seven catches, 68 yards. If you were quarterback,
wear it out.
You would have had double figures to him by now. First and 10 inside the 15. Hall slowed up and taken down. Nice play in there. Cameron Stevenson slowed him up, number 95.
Yeah, that easy running room in the first half that Andre Hall found is tough in the second half, only because this Rutgers defense is playing a little bit better, and two, there's a lot more bodies wearing red around that line of scrimmage.
37-31, Rutgers was down 21-0. Closed here to 37-31. Hart, his third TD pass, first of the day to Harris, coming early in the fourth quarter. Second and long, play fake. Got the tight end short, and then run down from behind. Otero Frierson runs down Derek Carter. Carter's first catch of the day, 4 yards on the advance.
Good. Derek Carter just trying to get back to the huddle. Looks like he's going to come out. Was tackled from behind. He's going to block down and then slide out to the flat. But a good job by the speed of number 50, Frierson. He gets back from the inside and then to the outside. This play should have been gone for a little bit more than a couple of yards. But a good job by Frierson.
Top of the screen, short side, Amari Jackson. Zone coverage. Tulmas keeps it to the 5, to the 4-yard line, close to first down. Judging for the mark, he's about a half yard short. They're going to bring on the field goal team. And Kyle Bronson, there's Rod Smith, the offensive coordinator. He's gone to Amari Jackson for 7 catches. I think 1 or 2 went incomplete. This will be a 22-yard right hash shot here for Kyle Bronson. He's made 1 from 20 already.
This is huge with that missed extra point earlier
sure
in the
is.
Game.
And the kick is blocked. Rutgers still has a life. Second one they blocked. Might have been Corey Barnes. I think somebody took it right in the middle. I think it was Val Barnaby got a shot in the middle. But Rutgers has the ball and 6:39 to go. A touchdown ties it.
Another look. The first one that was blocked on the extra point was a low kick. This time, Corey Barnes came from the outside, may have got a piece of it. He's going to come from the edge, number 6, the last guy on your screen. He does get a piece of it, and as well as Ron Garol.
So Rutgers, tough day for Kyle Bronson. Missed an extra point, missed the field goal. And Teal is in, Mike Teal, the redshirt freshman from Oakland, New Jersey, out of Don Bosco Prep. Ryan Hart injured the last time Rutgers had the ball. He'll throw it his first play. Deep middle. Man, there, caught first down. Sean Tucker on the deep end across the 35 to the 36-yard line. First down, Rutgers, a gain of 16.
Not bad to step on the field for your first play. Go a little bit of a drop back pass after play action and zip it to his wideout, Sean Tucker. Good protection and a nice route by Tucker.
Rutgers has the momentum, but can they cash it in? Plenty of time. 6:25 to go. First down from the 36. They'll run it with Ray Rice looking for a crease. And he's
nice ball carrier.
Good defense in there. 51 Steven Nicholas does a heck of a job. And so does the middle linebacker Ben Moffitt, number 59.
Yeah, I've been impressed all afternoon the way these linebackers run for the Bulls defense. They do a good job. And Rich Kravitz, the defensive coordinator, said, "I don't care who's running to the football, but if you're not running to the football, you'll be standing next to me on the sidelines."
Yeah. Let's get throwing down right here. Second down and 8. Good throwing down right here. Let's see if they do. Play fake. Rice got it. Spins. Close to first down. Across the 45, it'll be about a half a yard short. Terrence Royal makes the stop. Royal, they've seen a lot of him today. He's been outstanding, number 56, with a pick and a fumble return. The fumble return for a touchdown. But right now, a big 3rd and 1 for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights with the clock approaching 5 minutes.
Great 2nd and 3rd effort. Look at the spin move. He just bounces off of would-be tacklers towards the first down.
Ryan Leonard's the up back. Both he and Rice have been big today. 1 of 8 on 3rd down. That's what Rutgers has converted. They get quiet. They'll give it to Rice. Tried to bounce it. He didn't get it. Maybe the 2nd effort. Let's see. It's going to be close. The 2nd and 3rd effort might have gotten it for him. But a real good job to blow up that play.
I don't know, Dave. I think he's just short. I think he's just short of this first down.
Watching where they spot it. Yeah, it looks like 6 inches. And with 4:57 to go, a touchdown to tie. You gotta believe Schiano goes for it if he doesn't have it here, right?
I would think so.
Wow, he got it! He got it! First down Rutgers with 4:57 to go, and Jim Leavitt trying to pump his team up. He needs to stop. They've created a whole bunch of turnovers today. And 5 turnovers by Rutgers today. 3 picks, 2 fumbles. 4 turnovers.
Great chance to attack the middle of the field after play action on first down here, Dave.
8 men in the box. They run it and stopped in the backfield. Outstanding performance. Tim Jones, number 99, beat his man and slowed up Rice in the backfield.
Good pursuit by the Bulls defensively. They own that line of scrimmage on first down. Jones just coming back from, he was nicked up earlier in the game, comes back in. A lot of guys nicked up today. Very physical football game.
Tucker and Rice go to the far side, top of the screen, with 4:12 to go in a 6-point ball game. Teal, they pick up the blitz. Teal flush, throws short. Oh, and had interception written all over it. He threw it right to Mike Jenkins. Another turnover. That was number 5. I didn't see who the intended receiver was, but Jenkins was clearly the closest man there.
I don't think there was one, Dave. I think it was just a situation where Mike Teal felt a little bit uncomfortable, and he's a freshman quarterback, and he's thrown some interceptions this year. He's come into the game with 7 interceptions and only 2 touchdowns. That time he would have loved just to have thrown it over the bench of the Bulls, but you'll be able to watch. Nobody really there to catch the football wearing red.
Oh, my. He saw, there's number 4, Tucker, and he threw it way over his head. There's Tucker, was the closest man. That was it. Bad throw, should have thrown it away.
If you're going to throw the football away, throw it away. Throw it out of bounds.
Now they got to play strip of the ball, and Hall. Throw Jacoby in there, number 57. Redshirt junior from Rahway, New Jersey. Joe is the center, and they moved him over to D-line. Right now, the best friend for South Florida, 2, actually, the scoreboard and that clock as
yeah,
it runs
down. Yeah, that clock, pretty good friend as well.
37-31. Rutgers was down 21-0. 37-17. Leonard, a 1-yard run. Hart to Harris, a 3-yard TD pass, made it a touchdown game. Jomas with room. And banged out of bounds. He should have stayed in bounds. He got it inside the 40. That'll set up a 3rd and short. He picks up 7.
In this situation, as the game's going down and it means something, you have to be, as a quarterback, you have to be aware of everything. And right there, all you had to do was drop to your knees and go down and stay in bounds so the clock would continue to roll. And Ryan Hart on the other sidelines trying to get back into this football game. He was injured a couple series ago. Looks like he's trying to warm up to get back in if he gets another chance.
If he gets, exactly right. His defense has got to get a turnover right now. And South Florida, with intentions of winning the Big East Conference if it runs the remainder of its schedule, holding on for dear life here against Rutgers. 3rd down and short. Hall got it. And then some across the 35 to the 34-yard line. 1st down, Bulls. And our outstanding back of the game, brought to you about by Outback Steakhouse, is Andre Hall. And he's put up some serious numbers. Look at that, 32 for 143, just under 5 a carry. And he's
been outstanding today. The tough runs inside the 5-yard line really account for all of his touchdowns.
And he'll get the carry right here. They walled it off. Runs through Frierson. Frierson, though, grabs on and throws him down. So Rutgers got to start using some timeouts as the clock runs down to 2:48. The Teal interception was absolutely murder, and it may prevent Rutgers from winning this ball game. We'll be back to Piscataway in a moment. South Florida trying to batten down the hatches on a win here at Rutgers, 37-31. In the 4th, they've gotten the ball back after an interception, poorly thrown ball, and poor decision by Teal, Mike Teal. Here's Jomas, and I'm sure they told him to keep it in bounds, which he did there as he takes it to the 27-yard line, and a timeout called by the Rutgers Scarlet Knights with 2:40 to go here in the 4th quarter, a 1-possession game. Today's game has been brought to you by Cooper Tires, proud to be the official tire of the Big East Conference. Cooper Tires, don't give up a thing. Guinness Draft Stout, drink responsibly. Brilliant. Outback Steakhouse, no rules, just right. And by Pontiac, 10 models, each one designed for action. South Florida Bulls trying to put this one away now. 2:40 to go, 37-31. And Rutgers had that brutal early loss at Illinois in the opener, up 27-7 in the 4th. This one could rank right up there because they were right there ready to do some damage here and take the lead. Right now, let's take a look at the Ameritrade scoreboard. And Carolina doing a number on Boston College, a 9-point lead.
Ouch.
Can't say you're surprised at that one. Texas Ball Club can really score. Auburn up big on Kentucky in the SEC. And Tennessee is not
what
a good ball club.
What happened to Tennessee?
They're not a good ball club. 14-3. This is your ball game right here. Third down and three. Ball's at the 27. 2:40 to go. Pitch play. Hall. First down. Inside the 20. To the 19-yard line. Andre Hall has just been a stud today.
Oh, he really has. And a good block on the edge by Johnny Payton, the sophomore out of Dade City, Florida, just helping out on the corner. Good pitch by Julmus and South Florida inside the 20-yard line.
Well, the Bulls looked dominant early, took advantage of a couple of defensive scores, got the lead up to 28-7 before Rutgers started to get back into this one. Hall's had 3 2-yard runs. That was the last time they scored. That was the last score, 4:17 to go in the third to make it 37-17. Hall's going to get the carry. Great blocking. Fabulous blocking at the 10, at the 5. What a great job by the tight end. Mike Ruger did a good job. That whole left side walled everybody off. Watson and Davis and Miller. Nicely done.
Well, you called it, Dave. Great job on that left side and good running by Andre Hall again. Great vision and balance shown, and that's exactly what Jim Leavitt loves to see from number two. But a good block at the point of attack by the backup tight end, Mike Ruger.
13 yards on the gain. It's first and goal for South Florida. Exclamation point coming up. They've got Ricky Ponton in there now. It's Ruger in motion. And Ponton gets the carry, cuts it up. Didn't quite get in there. Ronnie Giralt was there, as well as Glenn Lee to keep him out for the moment. This place got real quiet. 31,131 on hand. Rutgers bowl eligible with the win against Navy last week. Haven't been bowl eligible since 92. Didn't go. The only bowl they've ever been to, the Garden State Bowl, about 30 minutes north of here at Giant Stadium back in 1979. Great facility here on campus. Holds about 42,000. And they're in for touchdown, and that is your ball game. Pat Julmus takes it in for South Florida. They'll make it 43-31 with 1:44 to go. Okay, Julmus got hit up. Well, maybe he did.
Yeah, it's frustrating for Greg Schiano. After halftime, his team played so well to take advantage of great field position after bad punts, and the defense played so well in that third quarter to get them back in the game. But Jim Leavitt's team found a way to win in the fourth quarter, and they still have the Big East Championship in their sights.
Sure do. Teal interception coming in off the bench to Jenkins. It was the big moment in that setting up that drive. 26 points off of turnovers today by South Florida. Wow.
Yeah, their defense set the tone early. They played well, and they were playing fast. And it looked like a team that hadn't missed a beat. They hadn't played in 3 weeks, and they came out defensively, played well. But the running attack of Andre Hall was just terrific. That offensive line for the Bulls set the tone. They really dominated the line of scrimmage early in this game.
9 plays, 46 yards, and 218. Good scoring drive. And that was a 1-yard run by Pat Julmist.
Hey, right here.
Right up here,
that's for you, baby. Hey. We love you, cuz.
Right up. Hey, we love
rest
you.
In peace. Baby. Rest in peace.
I'm going to see you at the crossroads, baby.
So the South Florida Bulls come in and just put a large dose of disappointment on top of Rutgers here today. And the South Florida Bulls in the first year in the Big East Conference, and this is a program, what, 9 years old?
Yeah, they went from the trailer to possibly the Big East Championship.
That's how we do it down there.
And the folks at West Virginia, pay attention, because this is a team you're going to have to pay on December 3rd down at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. And they're going to go for two. They're lined up to go for two. Syracuse, Cincinnati, Connecticut, and West Virginia still ahead of Jim Leavitt's South Florida Bulls. Team with good speed, good height on the edge there with the wide receivers and a fabulous running back in Andre Hall. He'll miss the Ponton, and he is in for the two-point conversion. And the two-point conversion is in. 45-31, South Florida putting the exclamation and the stamp on this one.
I've been impressed with this offensive line, and John Miller is the leader of that offensive line. But Amari Jackson and Andre Hall, Pat Julmas, they've all done a great job. But the story today, Dave, as you said earlier, five takeaways, and you get 28 points.
That's a lot.
Off of those takeaways.
Man,
I mean, that's
lot.
Just, that's your whole game right there.
Not a heck of a lot you can say to the Scarlet Knights after that was Jeremy Zuta, who was out injured today. And everybody in the Rutgers family, this one hurts. But a great win by South Florida. Can't say enough about them coming in after the long, long layoff because of the bye week and moreover the hurricane. And they come in here to get their first road victory of the season. Rutgers came in having won 6 of 7, but they're going to go down to defeat today. Thank the folks in the booth here, Bob Anderson, stage manager Rich Freesia, and John Lombardo with stats spotter Brian Prelo, and our graphics, John Kittering and Mark Vodonik, Doug Rutt, the director, and Jim Roller,
yeah,
the producer.
Uh-oh.
And Underwood at the 40-yard line with 1:38 to go.
Underwood on the return.
Big East football, we've had a roller coaster ride here today. Piscataway in New Jersey. Dave Sims, John Kinjemi with you.
First and 10 from the 40.
Rutgers down 21-0, as well as 28-7 and 37-17. Ryan Hart back in at quarterback. He took a big shot there as Trez Moses catches, gets out of bounds. South Florida territory, 38-yard line.
Jason Allen in the Bulls defense just unloaded on Ryan Hart.
22 yards on the game.
Good job by Hart hanging in the pocket and a nice catch by Moses. Still 1:33 left to go in this game.
I do remember the Heidi game back in 1968. The Raiders and the Jets. That's what it's going to take. But we can rest assured, TV audience, we're not leaving. Throw to Leonard. First down and more. Does the right thing, gets out of bounds at the 15-yard line. Nice play.
Two plays offensively. They covered a lot of yards.
24 yards on that one.
Good job by Ryan Hart just hitting the check down. Brian Leonard just finding a crease in the middle, going right to left, and then he uses his speed to the outside. People underestimate how fast Brian Leonard is because he lines up at the fullback spot. But this guy's got some wheels.
A couple of D linemen have limped off the field for South Florida. They do have 11 out there. First and 10, Rutgers. Hart in trouble. Throwing end zone, threw it away. Sean Tucker, the nearest receiver.
Nice escape that time by Ryan Hart. Just gave the defensive lineman a little shake inside the pocket and then did the smart thing, threw the football away. And if you're going to throw it away, throw it away.
Oh, yeah. Been there, huh?
Yeah. Sunday's not real kind when you don't throw one away like that. And Mike Thiel's going to watch that film tomorrow and have that same feeling.
Three receivers to Hart's right, 1:18 to go. Timeout left on the board for Rutgers. Down the middle, Hart tried to get it to Harris. He was there, too. Wasn't well thrown, but the receiver was there. Harris was open.
Yeah, it looked like his tight end was open in the end zone, and a ball on target may have narrowed the deficit.
All right, 15 of 24, 217 the yardage, two interceptions, three touchdowns. And Rutgers on the day. Third down conversion, 2 for 9.
A couple bad breaks with tip balls today for Ryan Hart.
74 seconds left. Bring a blitz. Jump the route, interception.
Night, night. Stepped out of bounds.
Sure did, but that officially put the cap on it. Trey Williams with a pick. So he matches Mike Jenkins in the secondary, his other side of the field cornerback with an INT. The turnovers today have just been brutal for Rutgers. 6 turnovers.
Yeah,
great job by South Florida.
Good anticipation by this cornerback and Trey Williams. And as you said, Dave, this defense has played spectacular. 6 turnovers.
4 of them picks. The man was there, too. It's all about timing, right?
Yeah, it is. It really is. And that time, the timing wasn't there, and it ends up in an interception going the other way.
...45-31, South Florida. Got to be impressed with these Bulls. First time we've seen them in person. We'll be down there in 2 weeks when the Cincinnati Bearcats come to town as we close out our 2005 Big East package. Tell you what, Cincinnati, you know, getting a little bit of momentum. They played well up at Syracuse last week.
Yeah, they did. They showed a lot of team speed, and they ran around the football.
And you better have a premium on team speed when you play the South Florida club. What a surprise. Only 3 players on their roster not from the state of Florida.
Yeah.
So you better be able to get some giddy up in there. Don't forget, next week, next Saturday, Connecticut will travel over to Pittsburgh to take on the Panthers. The Panthers got waxed this week, as did Connecticut. So both of them will try to heal up and get a W next week when we see them for our Big East game of the week. Next Saturday, noon Eastern, only from ESPN+. Connecticut pounded by a very good West Virginia club. And then Louisville, enigmatic Louisville, I guess you could say. You know, we thought they were really going to be something special. I mean, they're good, but they're not as special as we thought they were going to
be.
Yeah,
they're a good football team, and they're well coached, but I think they're a player or two away from being one of those elite teams.
Nice job done today by the South Florida Bulls, Jim Leavitt's club. They got the jersey yesterday, and I still love what the D coordinator, Rick Kravitz, said if it was under 50 degrees, we had to shoo them off the bus. They didn't want to know what could have been up here. I mean, normally in November, I guess the average temperature on a November 6th in this part of the country, it's got to be in the mid-40s. If they can celebrate, it'll be a nice ride back to Tampa tonight. And that's what you do. When somebody's going to turn it over, you cash him in for
Please
points.
Please reset the clock. 1:03.
Cash him in for points and get out of town, and that's what they've done. 28 points off of turnovers for South Florida. But Rick Kravitz, look at his shirt. Boy, he's been working. Rick to Jim's screen right, to Jim's left.
Yeah, it looked like he got the Gatorade shower and the water bath on the sidelines. And this was a big game. You know, they haven't played in such a long time to get back on a roll for South Florida and get some momentum built for the final 4 games of the season, because this is a team that truly believes they can win the Big East Conference.
Give me your thoughts on their upcoming opponents. I mean, how do you think they'll fare? I mean, they've got Syracuse. They've got 4 big ones coming up all in the conference.
Well, they've got Syracuse, and you know, they have been dreadful on offense, and they haven't been that much better on defense. So they've got good team speed. And I think they'll match well against Cincinnati, the game we have on the 19th. And then at Connecticut, you know, if you get a bad weather day, the Bulls, you know, they haven't been in that element. So who knows what could happen there. So you have to get through, you know, Syracuse to get to Cincinnati, naturally to get to Connecticut. But their bullseyes, you know, December 3rd.
Right. Give me a let me go out on a limb for that Connecticut game. There'll be some bad weather.
Yeah.
It'll be a little
chill.
It's
not going to be a Indian summer like we had today.
Exactly. There's no way. Very unlikely, highly unlikely you'll see this kind of temperature, mid-60s. But the South Florida Bulls take advantage of turnovers, make it pay, too. They put up 28 points off of turnovers, open up a 21-0 lead, extend it to 31-14, 37-17. Rutgers puts on a late challenge to make it 37-31, but a turnover. Mike Teal throws a pick, and it proved to be critical. And Rutgers disappointed and coming away with a loss as South Florida wins its first road game of the year to go 2-1 in the Big East, 4-3 overall. Rutgers drops to 6-3 and 3-2 in the Big East. For John Kinjemi and our entire Big East Plus, Big East crew on ESPN Plus, I'm Dave Sims. Thanks for joining us, everybody. We'll see you next week, Connecticut and Pittsburgh. This has been a presentation of ESPN Plus, the worldwide leader in collegiate sports television. South Florida taking advantage of numerous turnovers and making them all count. Talk to you from Heinz Field next week, everybody, on the Big East Game of the Week. We'll see you then.